Sirius 206, XM 103. This is Opie Radio.
Wake up! Wake up, wake up, wake up! Up you wake, up you wake, up you wake, up you wake! This is Mr. Senior Love Daddy, your voice of choice, the world's only 12-hour strong man on the air, and that's the truth.
Welcome to Bennington.
I don't know where I'm going from here, but I promise I won't bore you.
I want you to take your hand out of that bowl of Fritos, throw away your National Enquirer, and pick up the phone. Go ahead, pick it up. Talk radio. It's the last neighborhood in town. People just don't talk to each other anymore.
You would be very lucky if in your whole life you saw the work of one genius.
The form of the tragic autobiography is dead. Goodbye, written word. So I have chosen this form, radio. Author my life.
Hashtag Bennington.
This is Mr. Senior Love Daddy doing the nasty to your ears to the nasty. Eyes only play the platters that matter, the matters they platter. And that's the truth.
That's our house band, Arcade Fire, and this is Bennington. I'm Ron Bennington. With me, as always, is Gail Bennington, no relation.
Hi.
Arcade Fire is actually in studio and our house band today.
So excited to have them here.
Isn't it great? You know, the first time, and I'm going to date myself with this, I think, I heard that band, it was because Bowie was playing with them, doing this song. It was at some, like, fashion thing in Radio City.
So this is a couple albums in, then. This is the third album.
Yeah, I was on late. What can I tell you, you know?
The first song I ever heard of theirs was Rebellion Lies.
Okay, well, so you jumped ahead of me there, so it's a competition.
It's pretty cool.
I heard the Stones before you were even born, so how's that?
All right, that's fair. I'll take that.
Okay, so that means I'm going to die first. Actually, it is so amazingly cold out there today.
It's really brutal.
It's so cold in New York.
How cold is it?
I saw some dead homeless people. What?
It's horrible.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm just working this material out now. You know, like a lot of times if you go to see The Cellar, Louis C.K., it isn't what's going to be on the special.
Right, it's not.
You know,
quite
you work it out.
Yet.
Yeah. All right, what if I changed it to Homeful People? I saw a family that looked like they had a home, but they were all dead in the street from the cold. Good night, everybody.
It's a little better.
This is a fucking great special. Give me the $5.
I think you have something.
I hope so. You know what I mean? I know I want to do something with a dead family. And the weather, because that's current.
I got the first dead family joke. I got the second dead family joke.
And then I'm going to go back down. Their pet was dead. But first it had eaten them, and then tried to stay warm in their face muscles. Good night, everybody. I'm throwing the microphone down now. So that'll be the last thing I say, because the mic will be broken. I don't even think I'm going to throw out that whole bit and just start fresh. Go right to airline food, you know?
Yeah, start light. Something relatable.
That's what I try to do. I relate. I try to remember, think to myself, who am I doing the jokes for? And then I remember Ben Franklin. I thought it was a Mo Money Mo Problems thing I was trying to do. So anyway, it is cold.
It is really cold.
Now, here's my other problem, and it's the biggest problem any human being is having on the planet Earth right now. And I don't mean to be narcissistic about that, but I know I come at first. I left my phone at home today, which means I am cut off from her, my friend that guides me through life, and I pretend I'm dating my phone.
I'm more likely to forget my keys at home than I am my phone.
Is that right?
Yeah. I feel like it's pretty attached to me.
I also, you just reminded me, I don't have my keys either. I'm not used to the early morning thing.
You just ran out of the house in a complete panic.
Well, I got here 2 minutes before it started and was yelling down the hall, Arcade Fire, wake up! Because it's kind of like we're waking up now. It all ties in together. And then I was just writing on a cigarette pack, it's so cold in New York today. I saw a lot of dead homeless people.
You work so quickly.
I like to work quickly because that's where the muse is. Mm-hmm. That's what I try to do. Mm-hmm. It's just let it flow through me, you know? I'm a vessel.
It's like it's not even coming from you.
No, it's coming from, look, if you're a religious person, it's coming from God. If you're not a religious person, it's coming from science. It's the science that happens. It's the molecules and atoms in the universe working through me.
It's beautiful, whatever it is.
I think science is onto something here. You know, I actually came up with a scientific theory that I sent in to Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Is that right?
You ever been out at night and you see those lights up there? Mm-hmm. I think they're faraway universes or galaxies.
That's amazing.
Yes.
How did you come up with that?
Well, I also said that they're all filled with Asian people. Or Asian-like people.
Did he get back to you on that? Or?
No, he never gets back to me because he's Mr. Big Stuff now, isn't he?
He's a big shot.
Yeah, he is. He's the big deal. The big deal. We got a call from Ireland. as we're apt to do here. But you know why? Because on this satellite, we go out all over the planet Earth.
That's amazing.
Although we're not supposed to. We're just supposed to be in North America.
Hmm.
I'm going to keep this guy on long enough to trace his call. And then I'm going to call the IPD and have his ass busted. John?
Yes?
Hold on for a minute while I hook up this tracer. John, what can we do for you today, my friend? What are you mad at the English people?
No, I'm not actually from Ireland. I don't know what's going on with your phone screener, but I guess I could pretend if you'd like.
Okay, well, top of the morning to you, my friend. Boy,
hey,
phone screener blows.
Yeah.
What can we do for you?
Hey, you know, I hate it when the weather people say it's 10 degrees outside, and then they say, well, it feels like 15. Wouldn't the temperature be, like, minus 15 or something? I don't know.
No, well, they're saying there's a wind chill factor. A wind chill factor. That makes it feel like it's 15. So if they said it's minus 15, that would be a lie.
But that's the only
I learned so much.
How it feels?
Yeah, to me, personally.
Yeah, but that's not the way, I mean, we have to, it's like if you feel something, if you feel the plane's going to crash, right. You can't yell it out.
Right.
Because that's just your feeling. I learned that before.
You shouldn't do that.
When I started screaming, what's keeping us in the air? Magic?
What is this, witchcraft? Well, yeah, but aren't you really looking up the weather just to find out how your body is going to feel when you go outside?
So you actually think it should tell you whether or not...
Hold on, I don't want to totally agree with this guy.
You think like the Irish.
I don't want to be lied to.
Yes.
I mean, tell me the facts.
The only people that I want to be lied to is about our defense and our financial future.
Right.
I just want the president to say everything's going good and the market ticked up. And I feel oddly happy when the market ticks up.
Sure.
Even though I don't know how that affects my life even slightly.
Because that's none of my business.
None of my business. But the weather, I always wondered this too. What if they would open the news with weather? I bet everybody would close out right after that.
Oh, yeah. I bet a lot of people would.
Normally, I would look my weather up on my phone, but I don't have one anymore.
Oh. Would you like to know what it is?
Yeah, please, because I don't have a phone. Not having a phone is seriously the weirdest thing, because most of my life I didn't have a phone. Why do I think it's like a big deal now?
I know. It's really strange. We're completely... connected to it.
Out on the street, and I would say sometimes I call the street the feet, but out on the feet, it actually felt to me like people were staring and looking down at me, because I had no phone. Yeah.
So I have, here in New York City,
yeah,
10 degrees, but feels like -2.
Jesus Christ. I'm colder than I thought.
It's really cold.
You know what keep me warm right now is my phone.
Mm-hmm.
I cried because I had no phone. And then I met a man with no ears. And I started laughing at him. And I said, I bet you can't even wear glasses.
He just has to tape them up.
Ugh. Tape on the side of your head. What are you wearing, that Bosworth fucking crew cut?
Yuck.
Science! See, now here's the other thing, too. How do they know what the temperature is going to be like in days from now? That always weirds me out.
It's very strange.
They're like the 10-day forecast that I used to get when I had a phone. I would go like this. They will know 10 days from now how cold it's going to be and if it's going to rain in the morning and then turn to sunshine.
It's really bizarre.
That's magic.
But even weirder than that, how furious people are. When their predictions are off.
Yes.
Their predictions of the future.
Right. I'm sorry. Not everybody's Nostradamus. Some of these predictions don't come true. But that is, here's the weird thing. Like, what if, like, ancient people could see us, right? Looking at a glowing box that we talked to and then believe that box and what the weather was going to be 10 days from now.
We'd look crazy.
They're fucking crazy. We're the ones that have cars and shit, so you're crazy for using a crossbow instead of a shotgun. Sorry. You know what? I got a little angry, ancient people. That's me. I'm a little fucking proud of 2015 because that's how I roll.
God, really silly.
You know, they're the ones who started. I don't go back to where they live in the 900s.
Start criticizing them.
If I could time travel anywhere, it would be the year one. Just to be there when it all happened. Just to be counting down from zero to one. 10, 9, and we finally have time. And then I would take a lighter and amaze everybody until they called me emperor.
Do you ever think about the fact that if you went back in time, how little you could explain or actually help create anything? Like, it's not like I could tell about the advancements that we have.
Okay.
But then they're like, how does a television work? And I'm like, don't know, but it's pretty crazy. And I can see things on it.
I can see things that other people are pretending to live in a house, and then I laugh at them.
I couldn't even really explain, like, how a camera worked, how a telephone.
One. They would probably love to know how you get water from one place to another. That would be, like, the most helpful thing in the world. And you're going, you know, like a pipe, and you turn a thing, and then water comes through the pipe. And then you turn it back when you don't want any more water. They would think that we were... They would be so disappointed. Like, he has such great ideas, but just doesn't know any details.
They would be no better with my arrival.
In the future, we have caves that we built ourselves, and then we heat them and bring tiny suns in so we can read. That's the thing, like, you know how you scratch on walls? We put it on iPads.
How do you do this? I don't know.
Most of the things that I'm telling you about, I can't help you with. You're going to have to wait thousands of years for that. Oh, one more thing. There's cars. Even though you haven't figured out how to get a horse to take you places, we've done away with the horse. What do you think would be the most helpful thing to take back to them? I mean, depending on the year that we were looking at.
Right. Modern medicine?
Medicines?
Medicine,
they would just get high.
Like refrigeration or like...
I mean, if I took painkillers back to them, I'm sure the two biggest guys would just eat all the painkillers. And then I'll go like this. All right, there's not going to be any more painkillers because you couldn't stand up to those two guys with sticks. I don't know. I think probably... The best thing I could take back for them was like a can of cheese. Just watch them eat it. It's not only great, it's convenient.
Cheese whiz.
Yes.
Can you say cheese whiz?
Here's the thing. Here's the reason why I won't. Because when they started to put it on steak sandwiches in Philly,
no.
I'm just like, I'm done with you. I turn my back on you.
I know a lot of people from Philly who are... Pretty irritated that that became the standard.
But it should be irritated.
And now when you talk to people who are not from Philly, they're like, yeah, you put cheese whiz on. Like, everyone thinks it's the standard.
I hate those people. I hate when you go somewhere and they just try to put, like, a actual steak on bread and go, here's your Philly steak sandwich.
Incorrect.
No, not correct at all.
When did the cheese whiz thing start?
Some mayor or some shit did it back, you know what I mean? He's like, I like a little cheese whiz on it. And all the other lazy people jumped on top of it. They had just blown up moves, so everybody in the Philly, you know, was like, we're taking the city back. No, I don't think it was him. It was like one of their white males. I'm sure we can find this on Wikipedia somewhere, but I don't have a phone. Look, Adrian's on it. He's just going like a bat out of hell. Find out where the fucking thing started. Jeez, hashtag Bennington blowing up today.
Is that right?
The man with no ears would have to wear Kurt Ramis strap-on glasses. Hashtag Bennington. Things that make Friday better. Pizza. Hashtag Bennington. There's something just really happy about Gail's laugh on hashtag Bennington.
Oh,
well, I have a laugh too. Let's remember two people.
Two people.
Liz Sets Fire has been sick for days.
I hope she feels better.
And then Johnny Hard Rock says, I thought Ron was mad at me because he didn't return my texts, but he left his phone at home. Hashtag Bennington.
That one's so personal.
It really is personal, but he always goes out of his way. Really good friends with those guys. So I've got the hotline number.
This cheese whiz thing is a mystery.
By the way, on that band, the Arcade Fire, it always sounds to me, now this might sound insane, so if it does, we can cut it out of the replay.
Okay.
But it always sounds like Daniel Johnston is singing that song. Now that I'm older.
No, I see what you're saying. I've never really made that connection.
Yeah, of course you didn't make that connection because you're running around with your own phone. Now that I don't have a phone, I have the time to think.
We need a Daniel Johnston house band situation. No.
You know, I had him on the Ron Fez show one time, and it was the most amazing thing because he said Dave brought in a Casio, and he just started playing on this toy Casio, and it was unbelievable.
That's so cool.
And then I go like this, would you just draw some stuff for me and sign it? Thank you. Because I think his drawings are very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? I was going to say expensive. Is that a word? I would look it up on my phone, but I can't.
You're lost.
You know, the thing is, I don't have a phone, but I don't bring it up much, you know?
That's what's so great about you.
Yeah.
You wouldn't even know that you didn't have
it. No. No, because I'm like, that's my responsibility.
He came in with his dad, right? His dad came.
Yeah, but just sat in the background. His dad or his brother? No, I think it was his brother.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And they were very, you know, very polite people. Thank you for having Daniel. You know how the Southern people are always like that.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. They don't care who you are. They love the yes, sir, you.
They do.
It's politeness. Mm-hmm. That's why I finally hope that our next president is a Southern white man.
I know.
So we can get back to business. The business of America making money. I don't even think I'm voting this next time.
No?
No. Either that or it's a writing vote for a curse word of some type.
The other F?
I don't know which one it'll be. You know, it might even be the first F for all I know. The original F.
My favorite F.
Oh, look at the game tonight. New York Knicks against the Brooklyn Nets. This is basically like two bad high schools playing against each other for bragging rights of the East River. Whoever loses that game should be drowned. Not what I was going to say. Drowned it. Now that I'm older.
That's a good impression.
You know, yeah, like, that's the thing. I have a gift of impressions.
Maybe you should start a cover band.
Well, I'm going to start a cover band of David Coverdale songs and call it Coverdale Covers. Dales. My name is Dale, and I cover David Coverdale. I don't know why I talk like this. When I start singing, I'm going to sound just like him. But as of right now, I'm just going to sing as fuck. You're too young to remember when America danced the white snake.
Check this out.
Adrian, lay it on us. What happened?
According to this website, Frank Sr. first started putting whiz on cheesesteaks in the 50s.
What do you mean Frank Sr.? Who's
from Pat's?
But that's bullshit. Who was the guy? There was a mayor who made it popular because in the 50s no one did it. You know, those people at Pat's lie about everything. And so do their stupid neighbors.
Yeah.
I drive by a spot.
Pat's and what's the one?
Not Pat's. They call it Pat's and not Pat's.
Geno's. Yeah.
Geno's. Which a lot of people go, do you still make hamburgers? Because there's a Geno's hamburger chain.
Oh.
That I think started out of Baltimore, but again, I could be completely wrong.
But you don't have your phone to check.
I don't have my phone to check anything or call people. I guess I'll just send someone a letter. Dearest Martha, since my phone went away.
Went away.
Well, I don't think she would understand it all. Mm-hmm. Older.
Would you be like very weirded out to receive a letter from a friend?
Yes. Because I actually got one the other day from a stranger, and I thought this is the strangest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That came to your home?
Or? Yeah. So I thought, it's like, you've got mail. And I'm like, what is that? Did this fall out of the computer somehow?
It's bizarre.
Yeah.
I can't remember.
But yeah, it's happened. I don't remember the last time I even sent a postcard. Or if I've ever sent a postcard. Now come to think of it. I'm in Myrtle Beach.
I did it once.
Did you?
I sent a postcard to my brother.
From where?
From Roma.
From Rome?
Mm-hmm.
Just, what was it, like a picture of the Colosseum? This is where gladiators used to fight. Just like me and you. Ha ha. Just kidding.
Actually, I found it in his bedroom not too long ago, and yeah. It was very embarrassing. It was like I was being very, like, writerly with my postcard, very romanticized. I can't remember word for word, and even if I did, I probably wouldn't share it.
I wish I could share these Italian skies with you. They're so beautiful.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
I was young.
Sure.
I was very excited to travel.
Rome. So lovely this time of year, and it's filled with Romans. That was nice. You sent him something, nothing for me. I was actually, Gail's brother is like really funny, but doesn't have any of the look at me stuff that me and Gail, you know what I mean? Hey, we're doing funny dances. But I was thinking this thing the other day, and I was laughing my ass off of how funny he is. So when he's a kid, he got some kind of trophy for soccer or basketball or baseball or whatever they hand out trophies for, right? And it was a pretty big trophy. And then he did the gimmick that he was carrying it around all the time, like Owen Hart. And he would just act like wherever he was going, he had his trophy with him. So that was making me... That was making me laugh my ass off. Then he immediately turned the trophy into an Owen Hart prop. And then he was arguing with you about something, but he wasn't really like he was making up an argument. And he's going like this. Yeah? Well, do you have one of these, Gail? And he was putting it up to your face. So that was making me laugh. Like, how does he think that he's right because he has a trophy? And he's putting it up. And then he turned it and just started, like, seriously poking it into your face. Huh? Do you have one of these? And when I should have been yelling, stop.
You were just dying.
Yeah, I was just rolling on the ground. Well, I was already really into the whole Owen Hart angle, you know?
Man, he said something that really had me laughing, like, days later while we were watching the Super Bowl. It was during one of the commercials. It was during one of the commercials, and I think it was...
Oh, yeah.
I think it was the one where the dad is
one driving. Of the bad dad commercials. One of the 18 bad dad commercials.
One of the really bad dad commercials.
Yeah.
And I think it was the one where he's driving his daughter. The reveal is that he's driving his daughter to Army.
Yeah, to Army. We're going to take you to Army.
And he just really, like, subtly, kind of quiet under his breath, because all the other ones, remember the kid had the blade feet?
Yeah, he had blade feet. Yeah, everything made you feel bad during the Super Bowl.
Really sad. Yeah. And he's just like, I didn't get the blades ready.
I know. And that was like really, it like you cracked us all up and we were like laughing for a long time. But the thing was, we were all diving at jokes for like hours.
It's true.
And then he just wins with get the blades ready, and then he just stands up with his trophies. Still carrying the trophy around.
He's a very funny guy.
But you have to be careful with stuff like that because someone's driving down the road with blades going, hey, that's not so funny, man. I have blades.
That's so true.
Look, can I tell you something? This is the weirdest thing. Stuff like to see people walking around after they have lost limbs is crazy to me. Because I remember like when I was a little kid, most of the older people would have canes. Like there was just nothing you could do
right. With
even a bad knee. So when they started doing stuff like, you see this guy playing basketball? He doesn't have any legs. And you're like, what?
It's pretty
cool. It's amazing.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
And like the way that their movement has become so like fluid, like what they've done with the actual like structure.
Oh, it's ridiculous. Well,
like the design of them now is insane.
Yeah. But the blade is a shock because people are picking blades over like mechanical legs.
Yeah.
And here's my prediction and write it down today. 1993, mm-hmm. June 4th. This is when I'm predicting this. people in the future, there will be somebody with blades on a hockey team, and he's going to be amazing. And he won't wear skates. It'll just be his own blades.
What? Yeah. That would be insane.
And everybody's going to yell at him, "You braid runner! You braid runner!" It's another one of my impressions I do.
It's really good.
I noticed this water I got today, only single cupped. Mm-hmm. E-Rock likes to get me two cups.
I know. But that waitress came by. Single cup.
Thick stashed waitress. Nick, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, what's up, Ronnie B?
Yeah.
I just had a quick, I gotta give this disclaimer, first of all, like, I'm not a conspiracy theorist, I'm kind of an agnostic on that stuff, like...
Thank you so much for clearing that out, my friend.
Yeah.
Because I felt like, here comes another conspiracist.
Yeah, no, man, and I'm an agnostic, like, I honestly wouldn't be surprised if, like, 9/11 was an inside job, I wouldn't be surprised if that was
true. That's why I know you're not a conspiracy nut.
Yeah. Exactly, and I wouldn't be surprised if it was terrorists, too. I honestly, it could be a 50-50, either way, I have no clue. But, that being said, man, there's a lot of, like, at the very least, very interesting coincidences. Like, for example, George H.W. Bush, George W.'s dad.
Who?
He made George H.W. Bush.
Okay, so there was a Bush before the President Bush.
Yep, his dad, George W.'s dad, he became obsessed with the New World Order. The first time he mentioned it publicly, like in a big speech, was September 11th, 1990, which happened to be exactly 11 years before, September 11th, 2001.
What?
Yeah, that's a fact. And now that was George W.'s dad. And then after he first mentioned that, and then you could just tell he mentioned it a ton of times, like he's obsessed with it. So you got this New World Order thing. The New World Order. Yeah.
New World Order.
Yeah, it's no one really knows exactly what it is.
Oh, I know who it is. It's Kevin Nash, Razor Ramon, Hulk Hogan, and Big Papa Pump.
Yes. No, yeah, I think
the whole New World Order thing. Can I just ease you into it? Because I joined the New World Order back in 1993, and we've been doing a pretty good job of keeping things moving along.
Yeah,
and we're tracing your call. And guess what? You're coming from inside the house. Wait, that's only to scare me. Did you say ooh?
No,
that's beneath you. You don't need to work blow, okay?
I didn't say that.
You're a nice girl. You don't need to work blow. So the thing is, just relax, Nick. We've got everything taken care of.
No, but and then you look at the movie The Matrix, just another interesting incident. Neo's passport expires September 11th, 2001.
What the fuck?
Back to the Future.
Nah.
Back to the Future.
Okay.
Tons of 9/11 stuff in that. Tons. You look it up on YouTube, some dude. It's actually a funny video at the very least.
There's nothing funny about 9/11, my friend. Unless you happen to be in Osama bin Laden. And is he laughing now? Fuck no.
Hey, he might be. Who knows? I think he's still alive, man. We don't know.
Okay, yeah, you're right. You got me. He's still alive.
He's hanging out with George H.W.
You know, you gave me just a lot to chew on here today. Matrix, the first George Bush. Back to the Future. I'm now at 50-50. I'm at 51-49.
I'll do one more for you. All right?
No,
the
don't.
The founding fathers there were tons of them. The Freemason, right? Whole thing. I mean, they were huge Freemasons. Like, everyone says, we were founded on Christianity. But really not true. Like, Jefferson was like a deist.
Huh?
Thomas Jefferson, he wasn't,
I mean, did you ever look at the back of a dollar bill? What's going on there, man?
That's all Freemason stuff, man. It's all
George Washington used to grow weed, man. And every good man needs a chick behind him. And that was Martha, you know?
She was a hip lady.
She was a hip chick.
Well,
you got me a lot to think about today, dude.
Dude, no, look at the obelisk. Look at Washington, dude.
There is an obelisk down there.
Yeah, it's an ancient Egyptian occult symbol.
What?
Like, look at them. It's the same thing like in the Vatican. You got the obelisk, and
my
you got
mind
a dome.
Is fucked right now.
Dude, I'm telling you, like, and the next movie actually that's coming out, that Tom Hanks, like that whole thing, is going to be about Washington. I think it's coming
out. Tom Hanks is in with those bastards. And Wilson.
Dude, he's a little naughty, no question.
Volleyball girlfriend.
No question.
Now, here's the weird thing. All right, so think of that movie, right? Castaway. His volleyball girlfriend was Wilson. His real wife, Rita Wilson.
Right.
Right? You get that? Dennis the Menace's neighbor. Wilson. Mr. Wilson, right?
Now you're catching on.
Wilson Phillips.
Holy shit. What was their big hit?
Wilson.
Don't you know? Don't you know? Just hold on for the new world order. Hold on.
So you see how it all ties in, though.
I hate talking about this on the radio because both you and I will be murdered tonight.
Probably, but who knows.
But do what I did, man. Go off the grid. Get rid of your phone.
Look at what's his name? Alex Jones hasn't gotten murdered. He does his whole career like that.
That's because he's with them, dude. He's a false flag that he's setting up one thing just to fuck with you. You know what I mean? While he's showing you this, they doing that.
But it's probably what it is, man.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's like that movie, The Road. You know what I'm saying? It's like all there. It's like fucking Grand Funk Railroad, right? We're an American band, right? Mm-hmm. Like, we're coming to your town. We're going to what? Help you party it down. We're an American band.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? That's what I'm saying.
I don't know why, but I trust that guy.
I trust him with my life right now.
And I especially trust him because he's not really into conspiracy theories.
No, he's not into them. But now, he's got me thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Now he's got me rumbling around. I feel like I took the blue pill. That's the weird deal of it all. Matrix. Neo.
All I'm getting from this is the Matrix is real.
One, right? Neo.
One. Right.
You know?
Trinity.
Three.
Holy Trinity.
Holy shit. There's more like it. Trinity wearing latex pants, jumping one building to the other,
mm-hmm.
right? What else jumps from one building to the other? Spider-Man, right?
Mm-hmm.
Spy, like a spy, right? Per, like this for how many? Man, who's the son of man? Man's son, helter, skelter.
Oh my God.
All right? It's all fucking there, dude.
You're blowing my mind.
It's the book of Revelations. In the Bible. What's that about?
I'm all in with this guy.
I'm all in, period. John, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie B. Hi, Gail.
Hi.
I just want to say that guy is not a conspiracy theorist. It's a good thing, too, because he just is on his first trip, and he just really needs to just mellow out and put on some Allman Brothers.
Seriously, it's the best thing for you.
Just ride it out.
Yeah, ride it out. We're going to put some Allman Brothers on here. You want the live album, Phil Maurice? You're going to hear some cheering. They're not here, though. Just fucking relax. All right? No, I'm not taking you to the hospital. Because then we'll all get busted, and I can't explain this. Let's just stay here. Nobody leaves. But he is right about a lot of that shit that he's talking about, you know, but no one ever wants to talk about
it. I know, he's dead on.
Right? Ferguson. All right, what happened there? Ferguson.
Right.
Chuck and Mass, what's up? Chuck. What's up, Chuck?
Yeah, hey. Don't want to send this show spiraling out to the vast corners of the galaxy, but JFK assassination may be a conspiracy. That's what I heard, so...
If I was to question anybody about that, I would have questioned, A, the limo driver for him.
Right.
Because if you go back and watch that, it looks like he turns around and shoots over his shoulder. That could have happened. Or JFK might have killed himself because he was depressed.
It's really possible. You know, I, years ago, was... having to write something about the Zapruder film.
Yeah.
And I looked it up online just because I was like, okay, I'm going to just check this out. And I just always assumed that I had seen it because it's so iconic. I've seen, you know, maybe clips and moments.
Pictures.
And then when I actually watched it, it was so shocking to me. I realized I had never actually seen
it. How long is it altogether?
Oh, it's got to be like 30 seconds or something like that.
I think it's long. It's got to be longer than that, though, isn't it?
Oh, it is?
They cut parts out, yeah. They cut the part out where JFK was adjusting himself.
Right, because you don't need to see that.
Well, I think it had something to do with it all. But you were shocked from looking at it.
Yeah, like I when after I saw it, I realized that I just thought that I had seen this before, but I clearly never had, and never realized how incredibly graphic and how much you can actually see the film. It's horrifying.
Well, I don't think they even put it on TV or anything back then. I mean, the nation was so shocked, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That I don't know whether we've ever completely recovered from it, you know? Oh, God. No, Adrian has put it up, and it's really, it's awful.
It's so horrifying.
Here's Eric in Jersey. You're on the Ron and Fez show.
Morning.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen. I was calling to talk about Prince William, but now you mentioned JFK. Everybody knows he was killed because of his opposition to Operation Northwoods, where that was the original false flag attack.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
But I don't know if you're familiar with Operation Northwoods, but...
familiar with it.
Are you?
A little more than I like to say. My grandfather was all part of that.
Well, listen, now that you're talking about Revelation, maybe I'm not the craziest guy in the room, but I wonder if you've heard that Prince William is...
Prince William in a can?
Prince William? No, he's not running. But I don't know if you heard that he's being groomed to take over as king of the world, of the New World Order.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I know that for a fact.
You know,
well,
that for
that's
a fact.
Why, you know, he's balding so early. Mm-hmm. Because the devil has no hair, my friend.
Well, you
matter of fact, that's how we
shall
greet each other. Mm-hmm. So we know that we're with it. The devil has no hair.
That's a good one.
Except for eyebrows. That'll be our code word to everybody. The devil has no hair, except for eyebrows. Except for eyebrows. Come on in.
That's pretty cool.
We're all here right now. Any of you fuckers see the Matrix? Matrix. Matrix. Get it?
Tricks like cereal.
Right. They made tricks.
They made.
Tricks
they
us.
Made tricks us.
Yeah, cereal. What's in the. Who eats cereal?
Kids.
And a tricky rabbit. Kids and adults. And sometimes for tricky rabbits. Kids and adults. Adults. Do you ever think about that for a second? It's adults. You know? Adult what? Adult swim. Right? What else swims? Dolphins.
Right?
Right? Get it? Finn, $5 bill. You got a Finsky? Okay. Finnegan's what? Rainbow. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Bow. Bow bridges.
What?
Yeah. Bridges connecting to land masses. Masses. Massachusetts. Massachusetts.
No.
Starting to get it? Starting to
I'm
come
starting
together?
To see it. It's
yeah.
A little foggy for me, but
right.
It's coming together.
That's the whole weirdness of it all. It's all connected, you know? And you just got to sit up and just keep snorting meth and thinking about this over and over.
It's the only way to the truth.
Yeah. That's the whole thing. But luckily, we don't have any nutty listeners here. Eric in Colorado, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Morning, Ron. Morning, Gail.
Good morning.
Personally, I think if I was investigating the JFK killing, I'd be seriously looking at Jackie O. I mean, we all know about women scorned. You know, I think that's where that, I think.
Well, she was kind of. It looked like she tried to get away after she shot.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, I really think she tried. I really think it was her.
Mm.
Well,
I disagree.
I think she was America's sweetheart.
I love that, Jackie O.
You like the way she talks?
I love it.
She talks like she should have been singing with the Velvet Underground. There she goes. Hi, I'm Jackie O. No one ever talks like me. I'm Jackie O and I'm a bad, sexy baby.
Sexy sexy baby.
Doesn't she have that thing like she's trying to do a sexy baby talk?
She does, yeah. It's a little whispery.
Yeah.
But then she's also got that amazing accent that doesn't really exist.
It doesn't exist.
Outside of her and Little Edie, her cousin. And like,
all right, do the accent. Do how she talks.
Well, I can do Little Edie. I can't
do it. Okay, do Little Edie.
Father never wanted me to go to college. I could read and write in French, but I could never speak it.
The only other person I heard with that accent is Drew Barrymore, which is odd.
Does she have? Yeah, I guess she kind of does a little bit.
Need somebody to run that board over there, Hicks. 866-766-0339. Here is Nick. Nick, you're on Bennington. How are you?
All right, Ronnie B. I got two answers for you today. Number one, Gino's Hamburgers was from Gino Marchetti of the Baltimore
Colt. Yeah, the old Baltimore Colt, Gino Marchetti. Tea. What do the English drink?
Tea.
Tea for how many?
Two for
tea.
Mm-hmm.
Six. Actually only made $37,000 as his highest salary in the NFL, but he made millions for the burger chain when he sold it.
I don't know why.
Yeah. Question, yeah, also the other answer today is, back in the 90s, I was a guest at a party in Maryland, and this guy's father was a retired CIA agent.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me, basically, the story was that Carlos Marcello, the godfather of New Orleans, had been deported by Bobby Kennedy. And Oswald was from
Patsy.
And was actually his uncle was a bookmaker for Carlos Marcello. And they put them all together with the same crew who tried to do the Bay of Pigs, which is basically CIA agents.
Is this Oliver Stone calling?
No, this is true.
But here's why I know it's true, because all the CIA agents always tell all the secrets once they retired.
Oh, I'm telling you.
I know.
This was a guy, my friend was from New Orleans, and they moved to D.C. later on outside of Maryland. And what happened was you had the godfather of Dallas actually answered to the godfather of New Orleans.
Who answered to the godfather of Seoul? Get on up. Get up and get on up.
Yeah. There was a guy
I understand.
Named
I know. You know the whole thing. All right. Thanks, dude.
All right.
Peace. Getting a little deep for me.
We've gone deep in.
Yeah. We're through the looking glass right now and through the looking grass.
Mm-hmm. Both.
Which is really weird when grass starts looking at you. That's when I get weirded out.
We went real deep. Real fast.
I feel like I'm watching New York One, and he's just reading the news to me in the morning. What's that dude's name? He's the king of Brooklyn that everybody loves.
Yeah. Why can't I think of his name? Because we've talked about him before.
We talk about him every day that we can.
I'm just blanking out. I can't think of his name.
Is it Mark Maron?
No.
Was he the guy that yelled, close the fucking gates?
Lock the gates.
Lock the gates.
Lock the gates on these fuckheads.
You just bought a gate. That's my favorite line, I think, of the whole thing. Because he's yelling at someone that can't even hear him. And I always like that. Then when you're so angry, you just yell that stuff out. 866-766-0339.
Pat Kiernan. That's
Pat Kiernan.
Sorry.
There it is. No, you got
came
it.
To me.
You know what? You got it, and whenever you get it, just put it out there. Kier beers. N, like the N word. All right, I shouldn't even go there.
Yeah. Don't
go there because.
Something's gone too deep.
Yeah. Well, you know, there's a story out that everyone's mad about now. In Style Magazine, are you familiar with them?
Sure.
Well, they just did a cover of Kerry Washington, who's from the TV show Scandal.
Mm-hmm.
And they lightened her. They lightened her up. And obviously, Twitter went crazy. And then in Style, look, there's the picture. Adrian just popped it up for us.
Oh, weird, yeah.
And then in Style Magazine said, in our defense, we were just trying to get her to look pretty like a white girl. And everybody went, okay, now I see.
Yeah, that's pretty
That's pretty light.
Significant. It's not just a little bit lighter. She's incredibly
Well, we did that before with my friend Earl, Earl Douglas, mm-hmm. and he ended up looking like Stone Cold. You son of a bitch, I'll stalk him and I'm right in there. Then.
Who got in trouble for the O.J. Simpson cover? Was that Time magazine?
I think it was Time.
They darkened
him.
Yeah.
They made him even blacker, like a killer.
Mm-hmm. Look.
They just really blackened him up. And then Time actually came out after this and said, well, we wanted him to look more menacing, like a really black person who kills white women.
Exactly. That's the look we were going for.
The look we were going for is like a black murderer. So we're trying to scare our audience. That's all. No one ever gets that honest with people. Just, well, we wanted to really, you know, scare the shit out of you, so you had to buy the magazine.
Really make him look extra creepy and black.
Are you trying to say he didn't do it? Are you saying it's a conspiracy?
I'm not saying that.
Okay.
I'm not going on record saying
I thought the person that actually killed her was a young Peyton Manning, and they covered it up.
Wow.
Yeah.
He'd have to be pretty young.
Yeah. Well, he actually threw a bullet at her. That's how. What an arm this kid had. Mm-hmm. No one ever brings up that she was killed by a thrown bullet. Yeah. He's just on it one after another. Adrian's all over the
he's
shit
so
today.
Fast.
Yeah, he's so fast. He's just like, I got useless pictures for you guys. This would be really great if it was a TV show.
That's beautiful.
Well, I'm trying to start a band right now, but it's so difficult, mm-hmm. you know, with the whole Spotify internet, you know?
Right. It's hard to make money.
Yeah, it is. It's hard to make millions and millions of dollars like Rod Stewart. I want to get Rod Stewart paid. I'd go like this. I quit this band because we're never going to be as big as Rod Stewart. Not even the Rod Stewart of the 90s when he started covering Motown songs mm-hmm. and did the American Songbook. Here's a bunch of songs everyone's already heard, but I'm going to do them raspier.
Might as well quit because you're never going to be that big.
I would not be in a band because I don't think I could ever be as big as the Beatles, you know?
If you're not going for the top, what's the point?
You got to either go for the Kang, Elvis Presley. I want to make enough money with my band just to hand out car keys to people in the audience. You're getting a car. You're getting a car. You're getting a car. No one realizes that Oprah stole that from Elvis.
I know.
He used to give people cars. Wow. Here's the two things Elvis would do. Here's a car for you. When you take this. Number two, could you drive me home? Because I just gave out another car. And I don't have any more cars left. I'm all whacked out on legal speed. You got any more of them diet pills? I'm going to crush them up real good. Snort them. This is a song I wrote when I was all whacked out on Reds. No one's ever that honest. I was all ripped up on poppers one night. Just fucking blown out of my mind.
I actually really like that era of Elvis. There's something kind of great about whacked out Elvis.
Just being out of his mind. I'm so high, I put on a jumpsuit. Standing up here, rambling in front of everybody. Did you ever hear the thing where he was bit? He went after the haters who called him a drug addict, and you just hear him just totally whacked out.
Oh no!
Just taking it like this is the kind of shit Adrian could be chasing after instead of pictures of Peyton Manning. But it's out there, and like he's just like, there's a lot of people out there saying Elvis is taking pills. You know, you're just like, dude, don't even bring that up, man. You know, a lot of those housewives have no idea. Even though the internet hasn't been invented yet, I want you to know you're a bunch of trolls and haters.
He was so wise to be on that so early.
Somebody tell Jerry Lee Lewis to stop calling me up in the middle of the night, threatening to kill me.
Oh my God.
They actually put out one album just as Elvis's stage patter. Just Elvis talking in between songs. That's how much of the shit that they sold. You know what I mean? Like, seriously.
Like, without any music?
Yeah, it was just him. Oh, here's another song we wrote. It was back when I was in Karate Man. Red, Charlie Hodge, get in here, and I'm going to flip you in front of everybody. There would always be stuff where he would, he put on like demonstrations. There's one right there. And it's just Elvis walking in with his big glasses on. And he's just all foot fist way. And then he would just trip his friends and throw them down and shit. And they're like, that's good, Elvis. That's good the way you threw me down. I'm never going to have to get a job.
Elvis always wins.
Elvis wins another one. Two of my best friends are going to come after me with a knife right now. Why don't we break here? It is Bennington. We'll be back in just... Whoa, that was crazy. It was a little feedback.
Sorry, that's my
we'll
fault.
Be back in just a few moments. But first of all, no one would ever know where it came from. Here's some feedback, Hendrix style. Excuse me while I kiss this guy. Did he invent feedback or did somebody do it before him? Up to that point, everybody thought it was a problem, and he thought it was like music.
I thought I just invented it.
Well, you did in radio. No one in radio had ever goes, I'm going to put my headphones right here on the mic.
I didn't know that that's how that worked.
You thought a mic was like a clothesline. We'll be right back. It's Bennington.
You're listening to Bennington. It's gone to break. Don't worry, it's coming back. Opie Radio, XM 103, Sirius 206.
It's time for a live read. That's where we read something alive.
I'm ready.
You know what it's about? Valentine's Day is next week. And her friends, if you're dating a woman, will ask you what you got her. Impress your woman and her friends. That's what I try to do. I impress my woman and her friends because I want her friends to like me. And you'll be a hero when she posts all over social media that you came through for Valentine's Day. So she'll go on Instagram. She'll go on Snapchat. I think she'll be up on Tinder. Telling everybody that you came through with one dozen assorted roses and a free glass vase for just $19.99. She'll actually say to her friends, my man spent $19.99 on me. Or then you could really impress her and upgrade to two dozen assorted roses plus an elegant ruby vase for just $9.99 more. Go to proflowers.com and use the code OPIE because OPIE believes in this. Pro Flowers is quick, easy, and delivery on Valentine's Day is guaranteed. Gail, you ought to give this to your man.
I'm definitely going to pass that on.
So then you'll end up, you know, go like this. You know what? Update on the $9.99. Use the code OPIE and get me everything that I want. And then I can go on social media and brag about it. Mm-hmm. Pro Flowers also makes it easy to check off the list. Even if you already have Valentine's Day plans, you still need flowers delivered. Because if not, you'll ruin it. She's like, took me out to dinner, but I didn't get any flowers. It's a must. Pro flowers are guaranteed to last 7 days or your money back. It's a no-brainer. The longer you wait, the harder it is to find roses at this price. Some of these roses can go up to $2 million if you go out in the morning of Valentine's Day. It happened to me before. I went out. I said, how much for a dozen roses? They said $2 million. I go, you know what?
That's deep.
I waited. I got nothing else. I want her friends to tweet about this and Instagram about this. Here's the $2 million. I'm going to write you a check. If you go to proflowers.com, you'll never find prices like this anywhere else. Go to proflowers.com. Click on the microphone in the right-hand corner and type in Opie. That's the secret place. That's where Opie sends his friends to the right-hand corner. And you type in Opie. And then a special thing opens up. And you're in, you know, you're basically in the NWO at that point. New World Order. And that's proflowers.com. But here's it. Go to proflowers.com. Do it right now while I'm speaking. And see if I'm lying about this. I've figured out how Whoopi's always getting great flowers all the time. And he's a guy who wears a boutonniere wherever he goes. And I'm like, he's up to something. Son of a bitch is up to something. There's no way you could pull this off.
It's pro flowers.
It is pro flowers. It's better than amateur flowers. That's where I went last year. Amateur flowers. And they were dead when they got there. And when I went to amateur flowers, my girl's friend, my woman's friends, all said to her, he don't love you. Them flowers is dead. And I'm like, okay, let's wait.
Where are they from?
They're kind of from Mount Pilot. It's a town near Andy Griffith, but it's weirder. There was a murder there last year. He don't love you none. Them flowers ain't even good flowers.
You don't want them saying that.
No, they will too. But they'll wait till you're gone. You're nuts, Ron. Everybody likes you. And then you go in the other room. They're like, we don't like him at all. We like the proflower.com guy. And that's what Opie has turned me on to this. He actually sat me down, slapped me around a little bit, slapped me across my face. Look at me! Trying to save your life! I'm like, what, dude? Just tell me. You don't have to slap me. And I'll never forget, he said it to me. He said, Ron, I want you to go to proflowers.com. Click on the microphone. And I'm like, I can't find it. He's like, it's right there. I'm like, where? I didn't even have my computer plugged in, okay? It was a speaking spell.
That's what it was.
Huh?
That's what it was.
Yeah.
It wasn't plugged in.
Yeah, you got to plug it in, all right, if it doesn't have a battery life. So you go to proflowers.com, and you stand there for a while. No, you don't stand. You don't, it's not a place you go to. It's a place you go online in cyberspace, proflowers.com. You click on the microphone. Because no one, if somebody hasn't heard this message, they're just going to go in and not click on the microphone. You click on the microphone, and then you're going to feel like, oh, this thing's come up for like a secret. You type in Opie, and then boom, you get these great deals. Now, you're like, oh, I'll do this like, you know, Saturday. No, you won't. Mm-mm. This deal expires Friday at midnight. Is that tonight, Adrian? Is that tonight?
Yeah.
All right. Tonight at midnight, this dies like those little things in that 80s movie.
Gremlins?
Yeah. It dies like a gremlin or you throw water on it or whatever. So you don't want that to happen. Tonight, it's all over, dudes. I can't help you anymore after tonight.
You got to get on it now.
I just got to check. Have I done 60 seconds? All right. I'm just going to give them a little extra. Because tonight at midnight, this everything changes and changes for the worst. Don't end up like me, a loser in loser town. This is why I'm alone now. All right, that's why I got a studio apartment right above a subway. Just because I didn't get the right flowers. My life used to be great, and I didn't get the right flowers. And I sit there every night just drinking just rock gut whiskey. Like, why was I so stupid? Why didn't I listen?
You should have went to ProFlowers.
I should have went to ProFlowers.com.
Mm-hmm.
Now, .com is something that they say for the internet. It's
right.
Part of an internet address mm-hmm. that you can go to. I go to it all the time, and I'll go, because you know what? I'm seeing a new woman.
Mm-hmm.
She's elderly. And her old friends are like this. I think he's not going to be good for you.
Same friends?
Isn't it weird? These same little vicious bitches are following me around.
You got to get out of this circle.
Yeah. I got to get out of this phone booth. So you go to proflowers.com, and that's on the internet side. You're going to go there. And when you get to Pro Flowers, you're like, I've done it all. No, you haven't.
Mm-mm.
There's going to be a microphone there. All right? When you get there, look around. Make sure nobody sees you doing it. Like if you do this in a coffee shop, just take a look around and go like this. It's cool. Right? And then cough. Hit the microphone when you cough. You'll hit the microphone. And this whole thing's going to come up for you to, you know, type in a secret word. And you're like, I forgot it. You're listening to Opie Radio now, so think O-P. O-P-I-E. He's a friend of mine. I know a guy that knows about flowers. His name's Opie. He and I worked this thing out for you, the listener. But we're closing it down at midnight tonight. I think if you go there after midnight, you might get a shock. But you go there and you type in Opie, and then it all lines up. You get these great deals, and your friends are going to be impressed with you. You're not going to end up like me, like a bum. You're going to end up like happy with like a wife and children and cars, and your boss would be like, I don't know what it is about you, but you're just doing better every day. We've got our eye on you. You might be heading to the head office. What's your secret anyway? And then you'll go like this. I do have a secret. It's where I get my flowers. I go to proflowers.com. Let me know when I'm at 55 so I can just slow this thing down and get out. I just want to hit it. Just give me a countdown. Boom, boom, boom. And yeah, give me like a 5, 4, 3. And I'll be like, proflowers.com. It's great. Proflowers. But I don't know. See, what I'm trying to say to you is this. And if I could just have a minute of your time, because I don't want to take up too much time. I want to get back to the show. There's 7 continents, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And 7 seas.
Mm-hmm.
But there's only one way to play flowers, okay? Proflowers.com. It's the most important thing that you'll ever hear. It's more important than your health. It's more important than your future. Quite frankly, it's more important than the freedom of the United States. Which some of them are BS, and I want to get political here. But that those fat cats down in Washington are getting all the great flower deals. Well, now I'm giving you one. Proflowers.com. I'm going to tell you something that I did not tell you earlier. When you click on there, there's also going to be a microphone. These are for my best friends, okay? These are from the real people, all right? The Glenn Gary Glenn Ross people, all right? Be a closer. A, always. B, B, C, closing. Always be closing. And close that check down tonight, proflowers.com. Go there, click on the microphone, write an Opie. Well, I just found out it's a little bit after midnight right now. You might be too late to do this. Proflowers.com. Microphone, Opie. Getting flowers, getting your life in order, finally getting somebody to love you, not for who you are, but what you're able to provide them with. Lots of flowers and vases and great stuff. You're welcome. You're going to thank me for this. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but your children will come out and say, my dad lived such a great life because what you gave him that day, what you were able to share with him. You're like the Saving Private Ryan guy. And I'll go, Hanks? And they'll go, no, Hanks, you, for what you did to me today. Proflowers.com. Beware of the Valentine's Day trap. If she tells you she does not want anything for Valentine's Day, what she means is get me something for Valentine's Day. Show her you thought of something unique and different this year and get her the gift she's sure to love. Sherry's Berries. Giant, freshly dipped strawberries from Sherry's Berries starting at $19.99. Go to berries.com. Click on the microphone and use my code OPIE. You can even double the berries for just $10 more, but you must code OPIE when you order over a 40% savings. Dipped in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness, Sherry's Berries can be topped with chocolate chips, decorative swizzles, or nuts. Enjoy giant, romantic, juicy, freshly dipped strawberries starting at $19.99 or double the berries for $10 more. Here's the only way to get this amazing Valentine's deal. Visit berries.com. Click on the microphone in the top right-hand corner and tap in OPIE. You can also order by calling 866-FRUIT-02. That's BERRIES.com. Click on the microphone and enter OB. OPIE. BERRIES.com. Click on the microphone, MICROFONE, and enter OPIE. That's how it's done, ladies and gentlemen. That's the way they try to sell you. But we don't need to sell you that way. Because it's Valentine's Day. And it's the most important day of the year. It's love. It's amore. Show her you love her. Get her some sherry bows. That's all. 866-FRUIT-02. That's Z-E-O-R, by the way. I'm spelling a lot of stuff out here. Or go to BERRIES.com. Click on the microphone. And enter Opie. And when that happens, you'll get her some berries. Because berries say something that you can't say. I love you, and I'm sorry the way I acted the rest of the year. I've given you what you need to succeed, folks. It's up to you now, whether you do it or not. Please, for the love of God, go to this. Save your marriage, save your relationship, and get her some sherry spatters. Thank you.
Crowd the plate, and he'll put one in your ear. It's Bennington on Opie Radio, XM 103, Sirius 206.
Well, I'll show you his birds. So. Tell him about it. You'll be able to get a great deal if you hit the microphone. It is Bennington. I'm Ron Bennington. Here with me today, Gail Bennington, no relation, just happened to have the same last name.
It's a coincidence.
It's a coin dance.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to put something up on the Twitterverse as kind of a hashtag caption contest. Maybe Fez will give us one of his great prizes.
Oh, cool.
Fez, if you're listening anywhere today, by the way, somebody wrote this on hashtag Bennington. Why are all the characters Southern? I do a lot of Southern accents where I come from. But the youngins call it country.
There's so many variations of Southern. I think you've reached them all.
Well, I did. The youngins call it country, and the Yankees call it dumb. But, so call us, Fez, and tell us what great prize you have. But we're going to put up a picture of Birdie, the world's greatest dog. And the reason that we are going to do that is because you love Birdie very much.
She is my favorite creature, I think.
It is one of the best creatures on the planet Earth. And sometimes when I will look at Birdie, I go, I know there's a God, because look at you, Birdie. You're beautiful. You're a bird and a dog. Your name is Birdie. Remember when she came over to the Super Bowl with you? She ran away from you and ran down the hall and leapt into my arms.
She did. She was so excited to see you.
It made me feel good about myself. So now, you refuse to pay top dollar for a dog. And
yes.
You will only... get free dogs that are adopted.
She is a rescue dog, yeah. She was found on the streets,
mm-hmm.
homeless, a pregnant teen on the streets.
Did she already had the puppies?
No, she was pregnant when they found her.
Yeah.
And then she had the puppies at the shelter. And then when I met her, they were already adopted because everybody wants a puppy.
Everybody wants this, like, blonde little dog. Now, these pictures that you took, I would put the initial hashtag in. As look, Wes Anderson is making a movie about a dog. Because those pictures are so funny to me. But this is what I was thinking. Is it only funny to you if you know that dog? Or is it funny anyway?
I'd like to think it's funny to everyone. But she's also my dog, who I think is amazing. So, I don't know. Perhaps it's only special to us, but...
I know. Well, I took one of the pictures, and then we put them on birthday cards, and we gave that to you as a Christmas present.
It was such a good present. These pictures are from her one-year adoptiversary. Her one-year
adoption. Is that what they call it?
I don't know. Perhaps.
Or you just brought it up.
Yeah. So it was 1 year on that day that she was adopted. Since I don't know the day of her birth.
Since the 1 year after her... I wonder if she felt bad when they took her puppies away.
I can't think about it because I get really upset. Do you want to hear a sad story about it? When I first adopted her, I was looking up videos on like how to care for dogs, and she was asleep. So she's probably only with me like a day or two.
Yeah.
And I clicked a video, and the opening of the video was like puppies crying, and she shot awake and started looking around the apartment, and I just started bawling. And I think I called my mom and was like hyperventilating. Like, she misses her puppies and I don't know what to do. But she's an amazing dog.
She might be the best dog ever.
I did. When I shared this with friends, everyone was really like, oh my God, this is so cute. And then eventually I had the realization that I had baked her a cake and put up streamers and put a hat on her.
You know what?
And they're like, hold on, wait a second. I just realized what I'm looking at.
Well, you know what's funny to me? The one that she's just like lightly licking her cake. Is that like a dog cake of some kind?
Yes, it is. It's a pup cake. I made it.
All right, so this is what people are writing already. I was really hoping for a cake horn this year. Hashtag Birdie, hashtag Bennington.
That's a good one.
Just one bite. Okay, one more. Oh, crap. Just give me the whole thing. Happy birthday, Pepper, all alone with no family. Hashtag Bennington.
Oh, this one's cruel.
Cupcake, cupcake, kiss, kiss. That's kind of a Fez feedback. Mm. How come he won't call us, I wonder? Does more humping and speaks more than Fez. Hashtag Bennington. Oh, I guess you can click on it to see full pictures. This person just writes, if you're not listening to hashtag Bennington, you don't deserve ears. When it comes to cake, I'm a first responder. Hashtag Bennington. Have cake. Now all that I'm missing is a centerpiece.
A lot of these are Fez related.
Happy seventh birthday, Birdie. Hashtag Bennington, because that's in dog years.
Dog years.
But you don't know how old Birdie was when you found her.
They thought she was two, but I think she's a little bit younger because she was doing some growing. She fluffed up.
My producer just put up a thing that said Fez on line 3. In Fez years, I'm 10. Fez bought me a birthday cake from Steak and Shake. I guess I have to eat it. Hashtag Bennington. This person said, hashtag Bennington saved my marriage by telling me to click on the microphone and use the code Opie.
I'm so glad.
Yeah.
You're really reaching the people.
Fez, what do you got there, buddy?
For the prize for the caption contest, hashtag Bennington, is Parks and Rec, a season 1 DVD pack signed by Chris Pratt and Aziz Ansari.
Ooh, that's pretty good.
Just those two, though?
Yes, just those two as we go into the final season of Parks and Recreation.
That's great. Hi, Fezzy.
Fez, how'd you like my live reads today? Because you do all the live reads on our show because I'm not allowed anymore. Mm-hmm. I feel like I brought it back in a big, big way.
Yeah, I don't see why you'd be banned. I mean, you did such a great job.
Our live reads used to be so beloved that they were traded. This was like 6 or 7 years ago. Some of them would go on too long. At one point, I kept bringing up Manson and Helter Skelter. And I would say, if you don't go and get this, there's going to be a race war. And some of the sponsors liked it. Some of the sponsors didn't like it.
It's not for everyone.
No. No, I don't try to be for everyone, man. I'm just trying to be for the real people. You know what I mean? Real.
Real. This is real. Real.
Real.
You're real.
All right, Fez, if you were going to do part of this hashtag contest, what would you do?
I would say...
That's good, then. All right. Dead Man Certs, hashtag Bennington. The cupcake and the streamers helped me forget my puppies, hashtag Bennington.
Oh, no. So sad.
That's Greg Glennon saying the meanest thing ever.
So sad.
It's called Gotcha Day when you celebrate the day of adoption.
Aww. Because it's the day I gotcha.
This one just says, I abandoned my boy! I abandoned my son! Give me the blood!
Give me the blood, Eli, and get me out of here.
I want the blood! Eli was so annoying in that.
I really didn't care for him.
It's gonna be hard to beat I Abandoned My Boy, I think. and that's just someone whose name is Joe.
Oh, just Joe?
Yeah, he must have gotten on Twitter really early.
The first Joe on Twitter. That's really impressive.
Sarah says, in the hashtag Bennington family, we don't force pets to say dessert names. We just let them eat the dessert. It's again a Fez thing because he said his cat could say cookie. You know, he gave his cat away.
I know.
Or threw it off Niagara Falls.
I don't know why. I would have taken that cat. That cat was really cute.
He didn't even tell anybody he was getting rid of it. Everyone
loved
that cat.
He's so petite. Yeah. I mean, that was what was really cool. It was like a really...
All I ever wanted to do was wash him because he was so unloved.
Aww.
This one says, I get to sit next to a table while Earl is stuck, tied to a lamppost outside. Hashtag Bennington. Fez just spoke more on the phone than in the entire month of January. Hashtag Bennington. Hey, Birdie, did you know that Ron Bennington has his own cupcake?
Aww.
Hashtag Bennington. This one just says jizz buckets. Hashtag Bennington.
That's not good. I don't think that
one
wins.
This one says I miss my children.
I shouldn't have told this story. These are getting so sad.
No, you showed weakness. I abandoned my son. I abandoned my boy. This cake tastes better than my ass. Hashtag Bennington. This isn't the perfect blueberry. Hashtag Bennington. Gail, we got any more cupcakes back there? Friggin' starving. cake is a standalone dessert. Hashtag Bennington. Little Carby Knight would buy those berries if he hadn't died from the cancer. Oh, yeah. I said that one. Wait. This got me in trouble, too. One of the sponsors, I said that their, like, icon died from cancer.
What?
Oh, yeah, from eye cancer.
What?
Yeah, I don't know. I just.
Why did you say, like, what was the.
It's called improvisation, Gail. You don't pre-write it.
I know.
Now I feel nervous that the show is going to end. Can I talk to you a little bit about those libraries?
I hope this isn't the end of Bennington.
I actually had to say to them, I know you don't like it, but at least it went long.
Mm-hmm.
That was my excuse.
It's the right length. And it's the quantity that matters.
Mm. Birdie has her own cupcake. Hashtag Bennington. After I finish this, I'll be alone once again. Hashtag Bennington. Sad. And then it's just somebody put a picture of Bill Murray up. So far, that's leading. Because all the hipsters love Bill Murray.
He's loved now.
Beloved.
In a big way.
Yes, in a big, big way.
Big.
Internet, all right, well, somebody's going to win that nice thing, Parks and Recs, signed by one of the more famous people in America right now, Star-Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Star-Lord is the biggest thing to happen to this country. Going way back.
It's pretty weird how that... His career just...
Yeah, he was just like this weird dude, and now he's the biggest star in the world.
It's bizarre.
Now he's doing, I think, it's called Dinosaur Island 4.
Mm-hmm. He dropped some LBs, and now he's,
Well, he got cut. Everyone likes when you get cut.
Mm-hmm.
Get cut, get strong.
Now they're ready to pay him the big bucks.
He deserves the big bucks. If you lose weight, you should get paid a lot of money for it.
That's all it takes, really.
Yeah. Then everybody says, congratulations.
You look great.
You look great. What did you get? Stomach cancer? Or what happened? You're so lucky. So they cut out your intestines? God. God, you're lucky.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, he dropped quite a bit.
Oh, my goodness.
Jack in Savannah.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Ronnie, we go back a long way. I used to listen to you guys back in the day in Hinesville back there when I was getting ready for PT in the morning back in 92.
Okay.
Listen, oh, man, one of my fondest memories is Storman's Palace live gig. Talking to Gary Spivey just blitzed out of my freaking mind.
I don't make you a bad person, my friend.
I know. I tell you. What I wanted to do, I know you're really up on music. I always admired your music knowledge. There's a new song out by the Waterboys, which are a well-seasoned band, big cult following, British, called November Tale. It's a new release, a new album that's released in next month. It's coming out, but it's already on YouTube. Fabulous. The whole album's great.
Well, I got to tell you, we're doing a No Request weekend, so I'll try to get it on for you. All right, Jack? All right, buddy.
All right, man.
You know, I think you can call Cousin Brucey and request songs, but that's not going to be my thing.
Yeah, we have the house band here.
We got a house band playing today. Our team, Canadian band with a Texas singer. That's all I've ever wanted.
Mm-hmm.
It's like if Buddy Holly was in Rush, which I always thought would be the greatest band of all time.
Sounds like a really
Buddy Rush. Which sounds like something gay people snort right before. I don't know if anyone remembers Rush. It's it also was called Locker Room. It was a little popper that you would smell. And supposedly it's what killed one of those in the closet famous gay guys.
I think that came back a bit.
Oh yeah, see, I never know when things come back.
But it's still kind of in the gay community. Interestingly, they really like them.
They love like their drugs in the gay community.
They do.
They
like the party drugs.
But see, gays are they've locked in and they're basically normal and average now, and transgender is the new thing.
Right, like the new outsider.
Yeah, and I can't wait for this Bruce Jenner interview. I think it's going to be the greatest thing that ever happened.
It's pretty crazy. It's really, it's bizarre that it's gotten to this point now where it's like, so especially such an iconic sports celebrity.
Well, people forget, you know, because they think of him as the dumb Kardashian dad, and mm-hmm. apparently they, but at one time in the 1970s, he was, you know, Sports Illustrated's Athlete of the Year. He was on the Wheaties box right. back when that was still an impressive, cool thing to do. He was the Iron Man. Mm-hmm. He was our hero. He was as, he had straight machismo. But if you go back and look into, I think there was a movie that he did with the Village People in the 70s.
Is that right?
Where he wore these tiny short shorts, like cut-off shorts, like right up to his, yeah.
Oh, wow.
And it's a like a cut-off top. And I don't know how we didn't see it then because it was the 70s and people right. were just like discoing it up a little bit. But that's him and Steve Guttenberg, and Guttenberg is just wearing tighty-whities too, walking down the street.
Yeah, he's no shorter shorts than Guttenberg there.
Yeah, I mean, that was, you know, Magic Johnson had tiny shorts. Larry Bird had tiny shorts. It was the time of the tiny short.
And the 70s were an ambiguous time, I feel. Like,
yeah.
There was a lot of fluidity with the sexuality.
Well, you had
and like
Bowie,
self.
You had Elton John, you had Jimmy Carter. Everybody was just wide open, you know. Now, my brother was back at home with his Beatles and the Stone, but he never got off of that, you know, mm-hmm. Revolution trip. What a drag. Too many snags. Now, I had drunk a lot of wine, and I was feeling fine. I was going to raise a cat to bed. Is there concrete all around? Or is it in my head? I'm a dude, yeah. That was the 70s. And that was why we did not understand that this man would later decide that he was a woman. Because there he is walking down the street, dressed like a Wildwood prostitute. But I can't wait for this because I don't know how far he's going. You know what I mean? I don't know how far he's going to go. Is he going to get the full operation?
Right. Is it just going to be...
Is it just going to be tits and nothing else? They say he's going through the estrogen right now.
Which kind of leads me to believe that it's full commitment. Because once you're starting with the hormone treatment, I feel like you're probably...
Well, I had read this, and I don't know how true it is, but you could take any man and fill them with estrogen, and that man will start and think like a woman and become attracted to men.
Hmm.
So you could kind of create a woman, like this is something that maybe we could do to terrorists, that we just
right.
fill them with estrogen, and then we... give them a sex change operation, then we parachute them down back into the Middle East and let their friends beat them with rocks until they're dead.
Exactly. A little taste of their own medicine.
Yeah.
Because there's nothing worse than being born a woman. It's the worst possible.
Yes. I mean, it's the lowest place. But remember, on the human chain.
Right.
Human chain.
True. Like, not if you're... like a seahorse, maybe?
Well, almost every culture has something that is like a toast that says, I hope your first child is a masculine child.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that was the part of The Godfather.
Mm-hmm.
May your first child be a masculine child. And you're like, really? That's what you're hoping for? That my child has a penis. That's what you're bringing up today at the wedding.
I feel there's also like a Jewish prayer that like maybe it's the Hasidics, like their morning prayer is like that they are thankful that they were not born a woman. It's one of their...
I'm going to adopt that prayer for myself.
Dear Lord.
Dear Lord in heaven.
Dear sweet Lord.
Thank you. Oh, so you're going like a George Harrison religion. I get it. I get where you're coming from. Here's Frank. Frank's in the BX.
Hey, Ronnie, how you doing?
Hey.
You think this is going to open up a lot of the normal, you know, like say the regular people that don't really know anything about transgender? You think this is going to open it up and shed a good, maybe positive or negative light on the whole situation?
Well, I can't help to think that it would be positive because, like I said, how could you not like Bruce Jenner for what he did for this country in Canada? You know what I mean? So yeah, people that probably have never thought about it.
He looked awesome in those cute shorts, too, back then.
Yeah, he looked fantastic. Where a lot of people was going like this. Do you got any Bruce Jenner shorts and half shirt? No. But, you know, here's the thing. It's like, you know that he must really want to do this. But I do find it... The operation part, I feel, is like bananas. Like, I feel like if you want to put on a dress, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
But why are you doing this to your genitals? Doesn't it seem a little dangerous?
It does seem a little
After
intense.
Joan Rivers, you know.
Absolutely,
died
yeah.
just getting her throat cleared or whatever she was doing.
Yeah, it's got to be a very risky procedure. And I'm sure that there's a very good chance... It's all just going to go wrong down there.
Oh, like, anything could anyway.
Didn't, yeah.
I mean, it's
you
hard
wake
if
up
you,
and like, didn't it, work out.
Yeah, it's hard if you operate on a good one, let alone, you know what I mean? Like, you know, like the one that you were born with.
Mm-hmm.
You got to watch out for the angry inch disease.
I know. 6 inches forward, 5 inches back.
I got an angry inch. But you got to say to yourself, if... You didn't really feel like you needed to do this. You certainly wouldn't.
Of course,
you
yeah.
got to take somebody at their word. If somebody who's like saying to me, "Okay, I'm going to split my penis and have it pushed inside," I'm going like, I'd see like, "Well, you're in the deep end of the pool, my friend. You're yeah. serious about this idea. You've given it some thought."
Yeah.
But I'd also read that the suicide rate for transgender people is like 46 times higher than it is.
Like post-op, you mean?
I don't know if it's post-op or just what you're going through. Right. You know, the whole Candy Says situation.
Well, it's no matter what, you're struggling with your identity, whether you are able to figure it out and become something physically that you're more comfortable with. No matter what, you're still inside in turmoil. So I feel like that's got to be a huge part of it.
I think if I was his friend, I'd have to say, don't do this.
Yeah.
I'm worried about you physically doing that.
Yeah.
Dress up like a woman.
Totally.
I'll call you a woman because yeah. you got the gold medal.
Mm-hmm. I'll call you whatever you want.
I would do that for any gold medal winner. Like if Michael Phelps said to me, I want to be a woman, I'd say, do you, Miss Phelps? And I give him like a...
Thank you. I'm way ahead of you.
I'm way ahead of you. Thanks for all the good swimming. But if I could tell you, you could take any sport, the Michael Phelpses, the 92 basketball team, I still put the decathlon winner above them all.
As the best athlete.
I think there's two really impressive things, and I've actually said this to Mr. Bruce Jenner when he came in. He came in and did the show a couple years ago. And I talked to him for like 30 minutes, never once mentioned the name Kardashian.
Mm-hmm.
Just talked Olympics. And I said, to me, the decathlon and the 100 meters are the two most impressive. One, you've got the fastest person in the world. Bam.
Mm-hmm.
You line up everybody in the world and said, run to that line, and you beat them all.
Yeah,
that's
you're the
madness
fastest
to me.
Human.
Yeah, because remember like when you wanted to be the fastest kid in kindergarten?
Mm-hmm.
Imagine if kindergarten was everyone on the planet Earth. That's cool. And then decathlon, you are the best athlete in the world.
Yeah.
None better. You can do 10 sports in like, I don't know, a couple weeks or a week or something.
After those two, if you had to pick a gold medal to have, what would it be?
Beach volleyball.
That looks like a fun one.
That's a good... I have never given this... I'm going to try to think about this. 100 meters, the decathlon. I'm going to throw in like the broad jump I've always been impressed with because...
That's a cool one.
You can jump further than everyone else.
Hurdles are cool. I think it looks kind of like...
Yeah, but here's my problem with the hurdles. You actually have to put stuff out there that didn't exist.
You like a clean... slate. You're not.
I do like a clean slate because
equipment.
Those hurdles wouldn't be like the thing about the hurdles is they know exactly where they are. They know how many steps are taken. I think it would be funnier to stagger those hurdles. Like some of those hurdles would be 3 feet apart, and the next one wouldn't come for 30 yards. You know what I mean? Like, and you're blindfolded. No one knows when you jump and when you don't.
That could be really exciting.
All right, I'm going to give you my next. I've thought about this long enough, and it used to be called the mile. I believe they call it the 1500 meters now. There's something about that. That's the, you basically have a mile, but those guys run it almost like it's a full sprint. I mean, the 1500 meters is very, very impressive.
Yeah.
I also like the 800 meters. How about for you?
I like diving. I think it's a beautiful sport.
It is beautiful.
And they have incredible bodies. Like, they're muscular, but not, you know, like how swimmers are like, scary muscular with like the like wing of muscle on either side. That's kind of weird. It's just like there's something very elegant about.
Well, they have model bodies.
Yeah.
Divers are built like models, and when they hit the water, sometimes their breast or gonads will pop out, depending
which,
on the.
Which is exciting.
Yeah. Not as much as it used to be. I remember back in the old days, they would all come out. And as soon as they had the first like underwater camera, everybody was just like cracking up at their house and just having the time of their life.
Because as soon as they hit the water, like after the, you always still see them picking their suit out of their butt. It's awesome.
How could you not? but I would say this, and I'm some, the problem with diving is that it's decided by judges. You don't know who really gave the bet. It's a pageant, really. It's a pageant.
It's the same thing as figure skating, where it's like, who can really say if this is the best?
It would be great if you just had the same person all the time, and it would just be like who Dave thinks is the best. And whatever Dave comes up with, then everybody has to agree with.
Olympic Dave. I trust Dave.
Here's Nick in Strong Island.
Hey, Ron.
Yeah.
No, I just want to say, I mean, you know, the 100-meter dash, definitely decathlon, but what about wrestling? We got, you know, the toughest guy in the world throwing someone around.
My problem with that, it's a little too foxcatchery for me. I don't like all the foxcatching.
I didn't see the movie.
You remind me of that guy, though. That's what's weird. Well, remember when it was just, they almost voted wrestling out of the Olympics. And I was going, you can't, because this is like one of the actual things that the Greeks did do.
Yeah, you can't take out any originals.
It's the second oldest sport in history.
First is prostitution.
First is track. So it's track, then wrestling.
I would think that the... Yeah, I would, you know, the thing about wrestling is you never really pay attention. No one really watches it until you get to the Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going crazy. True. Well, a lot of those sports are that way.
It's not pretty like some of the other stuff that you mentioned.
No, but it's probably the most demanding, don't you think, out of all the sports? I
wrestled, my dad wrestled for Annapolis. My uncle wrestled for one of the SUNY schools. I don't remember which one.
Probably Purchase.
I don't know about that. That was pretty much it. I just wanted to sign in and give wrestling its due.
Here's the thing. Are you going to have a son that wrestles and keep 100%. The family legacy going?
100%. He doesn't have the options thing, no.
You're like a Samoan family. You love wrestling so much.
Or like Bret Hart's dad when they made the kids all fight in the base. Dungeon. The dungeon.
Bunch of Long Island Italians. How about that? Hawaiians.
I'm fully impressed with wrestling, and anybody that could beat a Russian was always my favorite. If an American beat a Russian, the thrill I would have. The thrill. The Olympics is so great.
It's really exciting.
What do you think of Winter Olympics, though?
I get down. I mean, it's not as exciting, but...
It's a little too chilly for me. The last Olympics, I saw a homeless family died there. And what I like to do is a callback every 2 hours and 55 minutes. I believe we're doing our show again next Friday.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah. A little double down.
Yeah, this is the first time we've done two in a row in a while.
Yeah. I think maybe ever. No? Did we do that once before?
Well, we don't have such a history that, you know, we can start keeping records right now. But next time we will talk more about wrestling. Here's Josh in New Hampshire.
Hey, what's going on, guys? I think the debate between objective and subjective sports is great that you're having, but the biathlon and the Winter Olympics is like the double objective, right?
So yeah, the biathlon, that's where you have to make out with a guy, then make out with a woman, then go down.
Yeah. You make out on skis, no less.
What exactly? The biathlon, you ski for a while.
And then you shoot a gun at targets, and miss the target, you got to do like a penalty lap. It's the coolest sport in the Olympics, I think.
It's pretty neat.
I'd love to get a gold. Yeah, it's great. I don't know about the kissing guys, though.
Well, bye. I was doing a joke about bye. You know what I mean? Like we were holding the whole thing earlier, and, you know, we were being very progressive. They used to do a thing on the wide world of sports, and I don't think this used to show up all the time. But it was the skating event that you would jump over barrels. And when I was a little kid, I was obsessed with it. I don't know where and it was actually called. It was the most perfectly named sport. It was called barrel jumping. And you would just see this guy, he would go as fast as he could, and then he would jump over these kegs. And then sometimes his ass would come down on the keg, and all the barrels would go spilling all over the place.
And they don't do this anymore, right? This is no longer...
At least they don't put it on TV. But the wide world of sports, back when that show came out, they would show you, you know, events from around the world that you wouldn't do in this country. So, like, one week there would be bullfighting. Right. The next week there'd be some kind of... Look, there's the event... And you just go as fast as you can and jump over barrels. And it seemed like they were from Norway or Sweden to me. But, you know, it's like if you're looking at most sports, right? It's not, if like you're doing a broad jump or high jump, you normally add like an inch or two, not an entire barrel. Right. That you have to now, like going from 7 barrels to 8 barrels seems like it could take years of your life. And if you're going by that, we got it up on YouTube here. Most people did not clear the barrels.
I'm not seeing anyone landing.
Well, yeah, even when you did clear the barrels, you still landed on your ass. Here's Norm, Strong Island. Norm?
Hey, good morning. Good morning, Ron.
Norman?
Hey, how you doing?
What can we do for you?
Hey, I just wanted to talk to you guys about Bruce. I'm a former decathlete.
Okay.
I took up decathlon.
Radio show.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. Hear you, because you're talking the whole time.
Sorry. Yeah, I took up decathlon in 7th grade. Was my goal. Bruce won the Olympics when I was in 7th grade. And he was my hero, like every other kid at that time. And I achieved my goal. You know, I ended up going to the NCAAs, Division I decathlete. And, you know, thereafter, he was always, you know, a hero to me. And to see this guy, you know, go through these changes, it's shocking and kind of crushes that image of that, you know, the Wheaties box guy. And it's kind of tainted in for me, you know?
Well, it's just saying tainted because you don't understand it yet, but it certainly does reframe this thing because when you think about it, he was, as a young man, I think he was like 26, you could literally say the guy who did that was like the manliest man in the world.
Right.
And if the manliest man in the world is a woman later, that is a reframe. That's one that you shouldn't act like, I can really get this today. This one could take a while for a lot of people.
Wrapping my brain around it's a little tough. But, I mean, the image is still there. And just for your education, decathlon is over 2 days, not 2 weeks. for a week.
2 days you got to do that in.
Yeah. 2 days. The first day is 100 meters long jump, high jump, shot put, and then 400 meters. Second day is the high hurdles, the javelin, pole vault, and the 1500 meters.
So at any
discus. This yeah. is in there too.
I mean, you're you can't even walk after 2 days of that, right? You're just spent.
You know, it's interesting. There's enough time to rest between the events. It's not all that taxing, but you know, at the end, the 1500 meters. You know, the whole event was scored on a booklet that you know, if you scored X amount of time or distance, there's points of value for that, and your points would add up. And the 1500 meters, you could win by a minute and maybe gain 2 points. So it was really skewed
yeah.
toward more the physical events and the jumps as opposed to the running. And you could be, you know, 2 points away and still win and be, you know, a minute behind the guy who won it. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? So it's kind of crazy.
Well, I remember Jenner even set, like, a record at the time for most points that
yeah.
anybody had ever done in that. I mean, he was a and now here's the thing. When I talked to him that day, he goes, when he did that, because it used to be an amateur, the day that he got the medal, he retired, right?
Mm-hmm.
So imagine if, you know, Aaron Rodgers wins the Super Bowl and then just retires that day. Because he would have loved to go on doing this, but he had to go make money. He was 26, 27 years old and had to cash in because if you took any commercial endorsements and all, you were
right,
off the team.
Done.
Yeah, which is crazy.
You violate your amateur status and you wouldn't be able to compete. Which
so,
is kind of strange, but
he was your hero. You picked up the event for him. Does a part of you feel like you may be a woman? Is that what you're, is that the
maybe
concerning
that's,
part?
Maybe that's the conflict. Maybe I'm feeling a little twisted.
But here's what I'm thinking. Back then, and not, this is why I'm dying for this interview to happen. Diane Sawyer is going to do it with him, and I think she'll, you know, she's a serious person. I don't think she'll be, you know, doing a Maury Povich on him. But I'm so curious if back there, was he thinking to himself, I'm really a woman? Or is this something that dawned on him later in life?
It's pretty interesting. I feel like a lot of people say that that it's something that they're born with and then they struggle with and, you know,
right.
and it becomes just too much and then they want to, but I don't know, is it possible that that was not on his radar at that
yeah
point?
We don't know.
Another approach could be that he strove to be Olympic champion to maybe fight off his urges that he thought he was a woman but he needed to be a man, and that was the manliest way he could become it.
Yeah, it is. I've never watched any reality shows, but I know I'm going to be locked into this one.
Mm-hmm.
It's mind-blowing to me. It's like if Mike Tyson said, I'm going to be a woman now. I actually would have believed that Mike Tyson would have done it because of the high voice and that he was always saying he was going to have sex with his opponent.
Mm-hmm.
I'm making
he's
love
also,
me.
Abused as a child and whatnot.
Yeah.
According to him.
All right,
well,
thanks.
Thanks for taking the call.
All right.
Join the show, guys.
You too.
Thanks.
A lot of people signing up for Fez's gift for the birdie caption contest, and a lot of people are just turning it on Fez instead of just. And then
and he's providing the gift.
Well, they're also bringing up that Birdie had an unwanted pregnancy and has an outside family somewhere.
I should have never said that story. She did not abandon her children.
I abandoned my son. I can't see anything beating that. Here's Rick. Rick in Washington.
How you doing?
Hey.
I think that the individual monthly
your phone is fantastic, sir. He said the individual medley of swimming. That's the one where you, you know, you breaststroke and you backstroke.
Oh, yeah.
The thing about swimming is it's the only sport that you can actually urinate in the playing area. You'll never see that in baseball. But they'll say to swimmers, do you pee in the pool? And they all say yes, across the board.
No, they don't. Do they really?
Yeah.
Wow.
100%.
Because they don't have, you know, you've got to release, it'll make you faster.
Yes, you want to kind of drop the fuel. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like a plane coming in for a crash landing.
Totally. I mean, anybody who shaves all their body hair for speed is not going to have any qualms about releasing urine in the pool.
Yeah, I agree with you. And a lot of people who shave their body hair for speed, it's for crystal meth. And like, somebody will say, like, I'll give you some crystal meth, but first you got to shave all your body hair.
Including eyebrows.
Including eyebrows, which is, that's powder freaky.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a bunch of young girls were in here yesterday to get a look, good look at the kid from Walking Dead. Did you know he's like a sex symbol? The guy from the Boondock Saints, who's now in Walking Dead.
Oh, I didn't know that. Which one of the brothers?
Yeah, the one who wasn't Powder is the Walking Dead.
Oh.
His name is.
I never made that connection.
Yeah, I think his name is Rufus McGee. I think that's his whole name.
It can't be.
Hey everyone, I'm Rufus McGee. I'm glad to be here for a town hall.
It looks like it's Norman Reedus.
Norman Reedus. And I stopped in the hall and listened to a little bit of his town hall. And what I couldn't believe about the... Have you ever seen the show Walking Dead at all?
I haven't.
None of them are dead. This is Hollywood fantasy.
Wow. So they're just playing the role.
They're lying. Like all actors, they lie. Like all actors in Brian Williams, they lie. This Brian Williams thing doesn't seem like it's going away.
I know. They're really upset about it.
Well, they are upset. There's two things with Brian Williams. You know him as the news anchor who sees himself as a stand-up comedian and goes on every show and tries to be amusing. Apparently, he made up a funny lie about what he did over in Iraq. He claims that he was captured by the Iraqis and that they lit him on fire and cut his head off, and somehow he got back here. And he also told a lot of people that he killed Osama bin Laden.
It's just not true.
With a flying neck breaker. He got behind the guy, turned him, snapped into a tombstone. Stone Cold Stunner.
This morning I watched...
What were you watching this morning?
This morning I was watching where they had sort of edited together him telling the story to a few different people. Like Letterman was one of them,
yeah.
And on another show, and just like showing how it got increasingly more intense with him being shot at, and it just wasn't true. But it reminded me so much of I Heart Huckabees with like
the tuna.
The lady hates chicken salad. Tell the chicken salad story. Like it was just like this is like his one story he tells over.
I'm sorry, I have to snap a stick.
He hates that stick.
Yeah, he does. He hates it. The lady does not like chicken salad.
Come on. Come on, Brian Williams. Tell me a chicken salad story.
Brian Williams is sweating after a while, making the story better and better.
No mayo.
He can. No mayo. That was her thing. And that's when I told her it was chicken salad. You see that, everybody? He can get her to sell chicken salad. Eat chicken salad. Let's break here, or let's...
That's a good idea.
Break the stick, as we say in the business. We come back. You said you have a game that some of your friends play now.
Yeah.
I want to play it here. Let's see if we can get Adrian in on this, you know, because even though he doesn't have the last name Bennington, he seems like he could be one of Bertie's adopted children in an odd way. We'll be right back. You are listening to Bennington.
Champ, sit down, have a seat. We're all going to do a radio show. Bennington will be right back.
This is a robot. Valentine's Day is next week, and her friends will ask you what you got her. Impress your woman and her friends. You'll be a hero when she posts all over social media that you came in through for Valentine's Day. I'm just kidding, ladies and gentlemen. I do the robot voice just to show how you've been going through life. Living like a robot. This is Ron Bennington from the show, Bennington. And I want you to know something. Come Valentine's Day, you'll be able to come up with one dozen assorted roses and a free glass vase or vase, depending on what part of the country you live in, for just $19.99. Yeah, you heard me. $19.99. Or really impress her and upgrade to two dozen roses plus an elegant ruby vase for just $9.99 more. Go to proflowers.com. Use the code OPIE, just like Opie from Opie Radio. Pro Flowers is quick, easy, and delivery on Valentine's Day is guaranteed. You can't beat the price. Lord knows you can't beat the price and convenience. Get it done early before it's all too late. In a very Terminator 3 type way. Do it now. Or pay the price. Pro Flowers makes it easy to check off the list, even if you already have Valentine's Day planned. Suppose you're taken out to a picnic or ice skating, or you're taking her out to like a baseball game, like a spring training game. You still want to have some flowers. You need flowers delivered. It's a must. It's guaranteed. Pro Flowers are guaranteed to last 7 days or your money back. You heard me. A full week or they will return your money. It's a no-brainer. The longer you wait, the harder it is to find roses at this price. This price or any price. Go to proflowers.com. Click on the microphone in the right-hand corner and type in the name Opie because it's Opie guaranteed. That's all. Proflowers.com. Click on the microphone and type in Opie today. This deal expires Friday at midnight. Right now, it is Friday. Gail, do you know what your boyfriend's getting you for Valentine's Day?
All I'm hoping is for Pro Flowers.
You want to get to Pro Flowers?
Yeah.
Do him a favor. Take this live read and leave it. Where he can find it. He's got
put
to go
it on
to,
his pillow.
Yeah, put it on his pillow and just say to him, go to proflowers.com. Click on the microphone in the right-hand corner and type in Opie. Type in Opie. That's proflowers.com. Click on the microphone. Type in Opie. Order today. A lot of people don't even know this, and I'm just going to let this out there. It's Opie's the guy who actually picks the flowers, puts them in a box, and mails them to you. And he doesn't even get, like, he has a thing at his house. Like, when you click on Opie, it just sounds like this is at his house. He's just, you know, there's a red light that goes off, and he just goes running into his flower room. He grabs a dozen. He's, like, looking at this thing. And he puts them all in. He puts them in the vase. And he sends them to you. And it's Opie guaranteed. And the reason that he does that is the love that he has for the listeners and love that he has for love. You know, the fact that he wants couples to stay together. He's put this deal together for you at proflowers.com. The deal expires. Is it tonight? At midnight. It's all over then, baby blue. Then we can't help you. But Opie will be with you until tonight. Go to proflowers.com. Click on the microphone. Type in Opie. He hears it. He runs over. He takes your order. He wraps it up. He ships it to you. And he makes sure your relationship stays together. Do it now because it's all over tonight. Hey, everybody. It's Ron Bennington from Hashtag Bennington. And I want to tell you, beware of the Valentine's Day trap. If she tells you she does not want anything for Valentine's Day, it means get me something for Valentine's Day. In other words, you can't trust women. Show her you thought of her and you thought of something unique and different this year. Just not the same stupid stuff. You went out and got her a gift that she's sure to love. And that's Sherry's Berries. Always remember it this way. Sherry's Berries, our love, it holds on, holds on. Sherry's Berries. I don't know anything other than that one part of Holds On.
It's beautiful.
But that is Steve Perry no relation to Sherry Berry, but post Journey, where we thought he's going to go on and do big things, and Journey's just going to fly away to nothing. Well, now look what happened. Sherry's Berries, folks, giant, giant, freshly dipped strawberries from Sherry's Berries, and it starts at the low price of $19.99. No, I didn't misread that. I'm being honest now. It's $19.99. Go to berries.com, click on the microphone, and use my code OPIE. And you can even double the berries for just $10 more. But you must use the code OPIE. And then when that happens, OPIE will go into his garden, dig up the berries, dip them in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness. Sherry's Berries can be topped with chocolate chips, a decorative swizzle, or nuts. It's that simple. Enjoy giant, romantic, juice, freshly dipped strawberries starting at just $9.99. Or double the berries with an extra tenner. Just $10 more and you double your berries. Here's the only way to get this amazing Valentine's Day deal. Visit berries.com. I'm going to spell it out for you now. So grab a pencil and a pad or just start and write it into your phone. During the memo part, visit berries.com. Click on the microphone in the top right-hand corner and type in OPIE. And he'll take care of the rest of it for you. Or you can call and order 866-FRUIT-02. That's berries.com. Click on the microphone and enter OPIE, like many of you have wanted to do for a long time, and you order today. Sherry's Berries, our love holds on. Tell her you love her with Sherry's Berries. That's berries.com. Click on the microphone and enter OPIE. Order today.
This is Bennington, OPIE Radio, XM 103, Sirius 206.
the dream between the click of the light and the start of the dream. Between the click of the light and the start of the dream. Between the click of the light and the start of the dream.
Arcade Fire, Bigger Than Life. As if Catholics made good music, it would sound like that, I think.
That's very accurate.
Like little angels.
It's a religious experience.
I like to say spiritual experience.
I mean spiritual.
Hey, coming up later today, I'm going to do an Unmasked with Ed Burns. That premieres 2 Eastern on the Ron and Fed show on Raw Dog Comedy Hits 99. Also going to air tonight on this channel, Opie Radio, at 11 o'clock Eastern. And today's Bennington show will be available on demand right here. And then the next Bennington will air next Friday. E-Rock, as always, you did a lovely job. Are you doing your show this weekend?
Yes, I have a show tonight.
What is it all about?
We talked to Andrew Lincoln from The Walking Dead and had an opportunity to get in touch with a lot of the different cast members. So they signed a bunch of these Funko figures that we're going to give away tonight.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah.
Thanks. Now, is he the same Lincoln that was president?
No,
because that would have been gigantic. Believe me, you would have a gigantic show tonight if you got him.
Both British.
Is that right? They're all British.
Yeah.
Well, they say there are no American men left. They have to go outside of American if they want to find an action star. All right, Gail is here today. Gail Bennington, no relation, of course. But you said there's a kind of game that you play, you and your friends play, and if we like, E-Rock can join in the game with us.
Sure.
Our own Adrian, Adrian, you had something you wanted to add today?
Yes, former mayor and governor Ed Rendell popularized the cheese thing.
That was a cheese whiz.
That's
boy.
It. Yeah.
Big Ed Rendell, and he talks like this. Listen, this is Ed Rendell. The trash will get picked up. There's no doubt about that. The cops will be out there, and we're going to hold the neighborhoods. You got my word on that. Go Eagles. Go Eagles.
He's to blame for the whiz.
He is to blame for taking the whiz all over the Philly cheesesteak. And joining us as part of this game from the Ron and Fez show, a guy that I've known for almost 6 months, our own Chris Stanley.
A little longer than 6 months.
Well, I mean, really new. You know what I mean? Up to this point.
Years.
That's when you got close.
For years, you lived a lie, and then I found out the truth about you 6 months ago.
What was that?
That you're an ill-begotten son of a bitch.
So this game is called... I was taught this by someone else.
Okay.
She plays it with her friends, and she brought it to me. It's called P, C, and D.
Mm-hmm.
Pro, con, neutral, deal breaker.
Okay.
So you meet a person, you're falling for them.
Mm-hmm.
You are attracted to them, you like everything about them, and then you find out this one quality or this one aspect of their personality, and you have to say, is this P, C, and D, pro, con, neutral, deal breaker?
Huh. I don't know if I've ever felt neutral about anything, so I'll be surprised if I come up with a neutral. All right, let's play.
So let's just, we'll start with a light one.
Yeah.
P, C, and D. You got to say P, C, and D before.
P, C, and D.
All right, P, C, and D.
Okay. P, C, and D. This person is an incredibly picky eater.
Deal breaker. Not even close.
Right out the gate, deal breaker.
Con, not a deal breaker. How picky? Like,
okay, we're talking, will not eat any ethnic food.
Deal breaker.
Deal breaker, full on.
Yeah, no ethnic food.
That's a con for me.
That's a con you're just against, but you would still stay with her.
As long as they're not touching my food, I don't care what they're eating.
But what about when it's time to go out? You're trying to pick a place to eat, you want to order delivery, don't forget.
And they're like, I just like eggs on white bread.
Yeah. Do they have a burger?
Can you take the cheese out of the burger? Can it not be so Indian? Deal breaker.
Deal breaker.
I'll have to switch to deal breaker. You're right.
All right.
So we're all in on deal breaker on that?
It's a deal breaker.
It's a deal breaker for me.
Okay.
It's a quality of life issue.
All right. Here's one I'm going to try with you guys.
All right.
You meet a girl. She's fantastic.
Yeah.
You find out she's Asian.
No,
do yours. PCND.
Neutral?
PCND.
PCND.
Mm-hmm. PCND. PCND.
PCND. PCND.
PCND. Adrian.
PCND. Okay. PCND uses British slang. Like, go to the loo, or...
Is she British?
Take the... Nope.
Why would she say this, then?
You know what?
They exist. They're
pro.
Out there.
Pro.
Bro.
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 Oh, my God.
We want to go to your lift tonight, baby? Walk, whatever.
Cheers, mate.
The lift is the elevator.
Yeah.
You want to go to the elevator?
You would take her to a flat, not
flat.
A loft.
That's it. Flat.
You know what? You're a deal breaker for her.
PCD.
You're not good enough for her.
Bro.
Open a bag of crisps.
Yeah exactly. Right. That kind of stuff.
A-Rod got me. I'm a deal breaker.
Deal breaker.
I can't bring with her. I can't.
I'm going to go extremely strong con. But that's got to be considering, like, everything else about this person is A+.
But I would say this. For a guy to do that, it's even worse.
It's worse.
Yeah. Like, a girl to do it, you're like, stomp with your stupid thing. But a guy, that's psycho.
Yeah.
Because he's not from there. You know what I mean? You got no right to that.
What about if it's old English? Like, methinks.
Oh, no. Deal breaker.
That's deal breaker.
It's just a con.
That's
like going to Renaissance fairs.
Do you remember when Anthony and Eastside Dave came in and they were dressed for a Renaissance fair like they went to, but then they didn't stop it when they got with us.
No. Yeah.
So we were all hanging out and they were coming in and they were like, my liege, pleasure to come in. And we were like, oh, I don't like this too much. This is bad.
Okay.
PCND.
Never has a bad word to say about anyone.
Deal breaker.
Deal breaker.
Deal breaker. You gotta talk shit.
I don't an optimistic person. They're lying.
Yeah, and then you can't trust them.
Yeah.
We've got a lot of deal breakers, come to think of it. So far.
Well, Rush Limbaugh's kind of nice when you think about it. You know, like, just take a stance. And so is everybody on MSNBC.
Or you meet someone at a party and you're like, oh, God, he was just the worst. And then they're like, I don't know. He seemed kind of nice.
Oh, no. Deal breaker.
Yeah. Hate it.
And if they don't let it out, they're going to wind up snapping and, like, killing you.
Yeah.
That's, E-Rock, the fact that you brought that up makes me fear about the relationship that you're in. I think
I'm in a safe place.
You ought to call the pizza place. Hey, I'd like to order a pizza, please. She's got a knife. All right, let's go PCND.
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 PCND. Doesn't like sports of any kind.
I say just a con.
I don't even know if that's a con.
That's neutral for me.
That might be a pro.
for me.
Oh, yeah, I was thinking that could throw it out.
Exactly. I get left alone on Sunday.
Yep.
Yeah.
She goes out. She doesn't even want to be in the house.
Maybe exactly. She likes to putt around the kitchen, you know, make a little snack for you.
Little,
okay. You know, like,
get little
oh,
toys.
What is that? Like a Hot Pocket?
Activity pack.
Why is it a con for you? You need your chick there to watch every basketball game with you?
No, just it just doesn't have, like, you don't want to get your fucking balls busted all the time over it.
Why would she bust your balls? No one ever said she doesn't like sports. It doesn't mean she's trying to stop you from liking sports.
I've had friends who fucking, she's like, turn the goddamn sports off.
Never.
That impression of a woman.
Turn the sports off.
It was a gay man. Turn the damn sports off.
Honey.
I'm going to say neutral, but I would almost say this. That woman who's like constantly like, come on, feed them under the boards. Wide open. You know what I mean? Like, that would almost be the deal breaker.
Yeah. I'm going to go neutral for me, because now we're talking about a guy. I think I can...
Oh no, never be with a guy who doesn't like sports. That's freaky. That's Jeffrey Gurian. I don't trust a guy who doesn't like sports. There's something wrong there.
I've dated a guy who didn't like sports.
Yeah, there was something wrong there. All right, so I didn't think I'd ever have a neutral, but I think I am. I think that's a neutral.
And look, we're all over the board with
Yeah,
that.
We're all over the board
we're
with this.
We're PCND.
Yeah, PCND. You know, Adrian actually shocked me when he said pro, because it gives everybody a little chance, a little getaway time.
You need a little personal time. Okay. PCND.
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 Drinks milk with every meal.
Is it
even if you go out to a restaurant?
Oh, deal breaker.
That's a con.
Yeah, it's a con.
Neutral.
Wait, hold on. No. Yeah. Pizza and milk, you're neutral about.
If they're drinking
sushi
it, I'm not.
But you're looking
sushi,
at that.
That's what I thought of.
All right, hold on. Okay. They're dunking the pizza in the milk.
Deal breaker.
It's a deal breaker for me, because I can't watch someone drink milk that often.
If they're at a bar, do they order a milk?
Yes.
No, only with booze. They're not just never not drinking milk. Like, sometimes they're not drinking milk, but when they eat something.
Neutral, then.
No, hold on. You're drinking the milk straight out of the cow.
Oh, God. deal breaker.
No, you're already stuck with pro.
I'm just fucking carrying an odor around
everywhere.
Are you neutral?
You honestly could put up with someone eating Chinese food and drinking milk?
It wouldn't bother me.
I'd stab them to death. I take a knife and stab him to death.
You ruined some good barbecue with milk.
It's a deal breaker. I can't even be witness to it.
Is there anything that you drink milk with, though?
It's cookies. That's it. That's all you fucking drink milk with.
Yeah.
Rarely.
What about you, E-Ruck? Your PB&J? Would you cross
that off? PB&D for the PB&J?
PB&J works. But yeah, there's not much you drink milk with.
What about chocolate milk?
That's available for anything.
Yeah.
I mean, that's like just having a piece of candy. You know what I mean?
BLTs.
Yeah, that's a totally different
BLT
category.
And chocolate milk?
Yep.
Oh, boy.
Deal breaker.
Milk is really only for cereal. It's to wet cereal.
And cold fried chicken.
No. No. Huh? Don't.
But that's what I want. Is that a deal breaker for everyone?
Neutral. Sure, go right ahead.
You know what? I seriously could start dating Chris Stanley. It's like, so easygoing.
I didn't tell you guys, but this was actually a dating game. And you guys have matched. Okay, PCND has the exact opposite taste in movies and TV shows.
Oh, opposite taste.
Like everything that you would, anything that you would dislike.
You'd never watch anything together?
That's where there's a problem. Because for me, if you're saying you have opposite tastes, like different taste in music, I think I can live with that.
I don't know.
But movies and TV is too social.
Yeah,
you watch it together.
To sit there and watch. Yes. Yeah, that could be a deal breaker.
Then you're sitting around, you're watching Real Housewives or something.
Yeah, I can't watch The Bachelor. Deal breaker. Like, if there's no sharing at all,
I can't be with somebody who doesn't watch The Bachelor.
This isn't meant to be.
Trouble in Paradise.
Yeah.
The honeymoon's over.
I'd say for me, it would be a deal breaker if they just disliked one thing that I love. Wait,
one
what
movie.
Did you say about Better Call Saul? This is over. E-Rock, have you watched those yet?
Yes, I have.
First three?
First three.
They're great, right?
Awesome.
Yeah, they're amazing.
Surprises everywhere.
I have to watch it.
Yeah,
I didn't watch the Breaking Bad.
You don't need to. You don't need to.
Are you sure?
I'm 100% sure. I've never been so damn sure of anything in my life.
I'm in then. Didn't take much convincing.
PC and D. So
PC
we decided, for me, it was Deal Breaker.
Deal Breaker.
Yeah.
PC and D.
It's Deal Breaker.
I think it's Deal Breaker.
But what about, just quick one, quick PC and D. Change it to music.
100% Deal Breaker.
100%.
Deal Breaker.
Yeah, because I don't want to listen to shit music.
What's shit music for you? Electronic dance?
Like music that's coming out now.
Yeah. Your music, the people have to be dead for you even to listen to them.
Yeah.
Put on the Doors. How many people in your group need to be dead? 50% before I'll listen. what do you got? I like this game, PC and D.
PC and D. PC and D is cold to children and babies.
Pro.
Not mean to them.
Fucking giant pro.
Like, not necessarily mean, but just completely.
Perfect. That's perfect.
It's pro.
Like, trips them as they walk by.
How could you be around anyone who didn't like children?
I don't like them. I don't want anyone to be liking them.
You don't like a child.
I feel uncomfortable around children.
Do you understand that's the worst kind of prejudice?
Wait. You don't like children?
I don't like being around children. I feel
he it feels he's going to be accused of something if he's left
just
alone.
Just don't do anything.
I'm not going to do anything. I'm not. Children lie.
See? I had a guy on my show who was like Chris, and he was quite phobic about it. And we had, like, a little kid on the show, right? And then we all acted like the rest of us needed to do something. We left him alone, and he was, like, sweating. He was freaking out.
Oh my
and it
God.
Was the same fear that if a kid accused, no one would believe him.
But I didn't even know this was a phobia.
Oh, yeah,
this
has
got to be a male, a male-centric phobia.
Although I've met women before that were totally uncomfortable around children, like particularly babies.
It's strange on a woman when, like, they're just not warm to children.
But you know what I mean? To me, if you don't like children, you don't like people.
I like people. I like adults. I don't like children.
Do you like them on their 18th birthday? Is that the day that you're willing?
Even then, they're still kind of annoying.
What age are you totally comfortable?
I'd say 22 is when a person is okay to deal with. And even then, that's borderline.
It's pretty young.
It could be a sci-fi movie where, like, the Chris Stanley world, where children are taken away and not brought back until they're 22.
It's perfect.
That's a world you want to live in.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm gonna say deal breaker because
it's deal breaker for me.
I think people are not. I think if you don't even look over a kid and start laughing, that would to me would be like if somebody didn't like Birdie.
I know.
Oh, dogs are great. Animals are great, but
up
children.
Up to what age? If you don't like a puppy.
No, puppies are fine.
They can accuse you though.
Yeah.
How? You're in their
inappropriate rubbing. What is it, boy? What did Chris do to you? Where are you on it, Adrian?
It's a pro for me.
It's a pro.
Yeah. Same way.
I love kids, but a girl who hates them, I never have to worry about an accidental pregnancy.
An accidental pregnancy.
But that wouldn't necessarily be an accidental pregnancy as they duped you into impregnating.
Yeah. But a girl who hates kids is never going to miss a birth control pill or anything like that.
Seriously, you're such a dude, bro. E-Rock, where are you on this?
It's a deal breaker for me.
Deal breaker.
Yeah.
Deal breaker.
We only got a couple minutes more. I'm liking this game.
We have time for one more?
Yeah, we do have
or
time.
Or a couple more.
Yeah, we got a couple minutes.
All right.
So two fast ones, one slow one.
Let's do. You guys can jump in, too.
Yeah.
What about PC and D is a ghost?
They're a ghost?
Yes.
Pro.
I can see them and interact with them. They're ghosts.
Yes.
Okay.
They're visible, but they're not fully opaque. They're a little bit.
Pro, you gotta love having a ghost in your life.
Yeah.
That you're dating.
I do from the movie Ghost.
I'm gonna go neutral.
I don't care whether they were a ghost or not.
Take it or leave it. I don't care. I don't judge.
Ghosts usually mean they're in limbo, right? So if you're neutral, you don't care why they're a ghost.
You're so Catholic. Yeah. I've never heard anyone bring up, well, you mean they haven't been accepted into God's kingdom?
They're in purgatory.
So you're going to go pro or you're going to go con?
I'm going to go pro.
Oh, go pro. Go pro. Yeah.
Go pro.
Adrian.
I'm going to go con because then there goes that around forever.
Right. What?
He despises
ghosts and kids.
Women that like kids and sports.
He wants it to be a ghost who doesn't want children and hates sports.
He seems like ghost. He's planning on spending a life alone.
All right. We have
time for one more.
PC and D. Has dated someone that you despise.
Like Hitler or
just... A personal enemy. Someone that you really loathe, and they dated this person.
Okay,
not slept with them, but just like dated them for a period of time. Like a year.
They dated Chris Stanley.
Oh, God. Really?
Yeah. Like, could you be with someone who had dated Chris Stanley?
Sure.
I can't even imagine.
That's a deal breaker.
It's a deal breaker?
Oh, yeah, because you just keep looking at that person, and then all that person does is remind you of the other person, because you can't get that image out of your head.
Well, the person they dated is your enemy?
Yeah.
I'd say he's a pro, because then it's a victory over your enemy.
Oh, wow.
All right.
The Mongolian soldier picks. What about you, Chris?
Con. I mean, they'll be annoying, but not a deal breaker.
But a con.
Maybe it's
You're
a con.
You're not happy with it.
No, I'm not happy, but, you know.
For me, it's not necessarily a deal breaker, but is it a deal breaker for them that I'm going to continue bringing it up?
Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm going to bring it up all the time. That goes without saying.
I'll stay with you, but we're going to talk about this a lot.
All right, we ought to make sure every time we do a Bennington, we have a little time for this game, because it's a lot of fun. Ed Burns, Unmasked today at 2 o'clock. Also tonight here at 11 o'clock on OP Radio. E-Rock, your show tonight?
My show is at 8 p.m. tonight on OP Radio.
All right. And also a little later on, Sam is doing his show right here at OP Radio. What time? 3?
3 p.m.
3 o'clock. It's going to be a lot of fun today. He's going to have great guests. Everything's going to be fun. Gail, thank you so much.
Thank you.
For being in here today. We'll see you next Friday right here on OP Radio for another edition of Hashtag Bennington.
You've been listening to Bennington, only on OP Radio. XM 103, Sirius 206. You can listen to it again by going to Sirius XM On Demand.